This is Free Talk Live. You are welcome to join us here toll free on the radio waves. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. You can also join us online over at freetalklive.com. And you can get on the air with us on Skype as well if you have that. The Skype username for you to connect to is lrn.fm. You just send a contact request if you have not yet done so, and we'll approve it once we notice it coming in, which usually doesn't take much more than a segment of the show. After that, easy for you to call us on Skype, and you usually sound a lot better than on the regular phone lines. Joining you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Daryl.
And, of course, you can join us again over at freetalklive.com. Breaking news, and usually when news breaks, it's not good. I don't know. I mean, I guess there's sometimes where there's some good breaking news, like if a legislature, let's say, were to pass cannabis decriminalization or something like that.
True.
That could be good breaking news. But a lot of times.
Or if every politician resigned at the same time, that would be good news.
I agree with you there. Maybe self-immolation or something like that of a politician. That would be also good news. Maybe. No, what's it called when they not self-immolation? That's where you light yourself on fire.
Right.
Combustion. That's right. Self-combustion.
Spontaneous combustion.
Yeah. If the entire Washington D.C. 535 scumbags up there all of a sudden spontaneously combusted, that would also be some pretty good news. So you can join us here and share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE. But the not so great news is about our friend and sometime co-host on Free Talk Live, Damo Freeman, who has been arrested. And it's the first time he's been arrested in a few years, probably
a couple of years.
One of the last times he was arrested was for the wiretapping charges. I don't know if that was the last time, but I think that it was. He had gone to jail on those charges. Ultimately, the Supreme Court overturned them. And then I think, God, I forget how that ended
up. The charges got brought back.
Yeah, they came back at him with them again. And didn't he plea on those?
He took a plea down to a misdemeanor from a felony.
So he's sort of been waiting out the suspended sentence that I believe was placed upon him. And I don't know what the status of that sentence is. I don't know if he was free and clear from that yet or not.
I don't recall.
Yeah, and we don't have him here to talk to us about it at the moment because he is right now in a jail in Zanesville, what I believe is Ohio. I have to be honest, I didn't look to see the state in which Janesville is part of, but I know that Ohio. Ohio Cop Block's Dio was the one who posted about this over on copblock.org today. And according to the story, Adamo Freeman, the Cop Block founder, blogger, was arrested today for contempt of court in Zanesville. He was there to see about a Zanesville cop blocker who was arrested for obstruction for recording the police the night prior. And so he was there to support his fellow cop blocker during what was supposed to be just simply an arraignment. And this is a good example. This story is a good example of how it is that a routine situation like an arraignment can go completely in another direction from what you expect.
Yes.
I mean, typically when you go, for those of you who aren't familiar with criminal court proceedings, you get arrested and they set an arraignment date. If you're arrested and held overnight, at least, you know, this is mostly from my experience in New Hampshire. It probably applies in a lot of places with Western court systems. But if they hold you overnight, if you don't get bailed immediately, your arraignment will be the next court day. So
there are some places that have night court where they will do arraignments at night.
Those big cities, typically?
Sometimes. I remember when I was a corrections officer in not a big city in Pennsylvania, they would have middle of the night arraignments for the people that came in the middle of the night.
And when you say middle of the night, you're not talking about the evening. You're talking about literally overnights. They actually have a judge.
Like midnight, 2 o'clock in the morning.
There's an actual judge sitting on a bench?
There's a judge. I don't know where he was.
Huh.
But there was a judge that would do video arraignments. Amazing. Like, you know, between midnight and 2 in the morning or something like that.
So in this case, the arraignment was the next day. And it just goes to show that normally you expect you go to an arraignment. The judge asks you, how do you plea? You know, it tells you what you've been charged with and then asks you, how do you plea? Generally, I don't answer the question because I don't like the idea of pleading to anyone. And so if in New Hampshire, at least, if you don't answer the question, they'll just go ahead and schedule you for a trial. They'll put in a not guilty plea on your behalf, even though you did not ask them to. And, you know, you can't, the only way you could refuse them to do that would be to plead guilty. So essentially, you get a not guilty plea by not speaking. And then, you know, they schedule the court date. They ask you if that works for you. And that's it. It's the end of the hearing, typically. In this case, Ademo did not ever make it to see his friend's hearing because he was essentially in the, I guess, the lobby of the courthouse where he got into a verbal, a heated argument, if you will, with a bailiff who basically did not like that Ademo was using profanity.
Okay.
And he also did not like that Ademo had walked into the building with a hat on. Now, we've had experiences with this situation before with activists in New Hampshire who have been arrested, including, I believe, Ademo, for wearing a hat.
I know Pete court. Was.
I know Pete was. I know Bo, I think, has been arrested, Bo Davis, for wearing a hat as well. There have been a multitude, actually, of people arrested for wearing hats up here, at least two or three that I can think of. And so he didn't like that, and I guess he got on Ademo's case. So at some point, Ademo brings out his cell phone and begins to stream out the video from his phone to Bambuser. You can get the Bambuser app for your phone as well over at Bambuser, BAMBUSER.com. Great app, works pretty well. Anyway, so you see the first interaction with this blue-shirted bailiff, and the guy is trying to tell him about how there's this courtroom decor that is expected, and Ademo points out that he's been to multiple courtrooms where he's been allowed to wear a hat. And, of course, the bailiff is shocked by this.
This, again, is in the lobby, not in the courtroom.
That's correct. Well, he was trying to get him to take his hat off on the expectation that he was going to be entering into said courtroom. And that's what I think sparked the discussion in the first place. So the bailiff, of course, balks at the idea that there could possibly be a courthouse in existence where where people are allowed to wear hats. There are. It's the Manchester courts, actually. They typically let, at least Manchester District Court in New Hampshire, I've seen multiple people wearing hats in Manchester District Court. You generally won't get away with it in Keene, but I have seen activists do it, I think, in Keene. He also cited Massachusetts as well. So it can be done. It just all depends on the arbitrary whims of the man in the robe. If the guy in the robe doesn't want to mess with somebody for wearing a hat, he won't mess with him. On the other hand, if the guy in the robe wants to throw somebody in a jail cell for wearing a hat, he can totally do that because he's got men at his disposal who will essentially follow a judge's every beck and call. Even if the judge's call is illegal, as Ademo himself found out here, if you've seen Derek J's victimless crime spree, you may remember probably one of the more memorable scenes where Ademo is arrested in Derek J's victimless crime spree. He's walking up the stairwell in Keene District Court following a judge, as Judge Burke, as he comes in, basically coming into work in the morning, and asks Burke a few questions when he's on camera. And actually, ironically enough, he's asking Burke about arresting a man for a hat, for wearing a hat. And Burke, when he gets up to the courtroom floor, opens the door, tells the bailiffs, who are basically standing right there, that you need to arrest this man for contempt. He just threatened me.
Right. And if you watch the video, there were no threats.
No, just questions.
There was never a threat. There was, I want to ask you questions about why you arrested someone for wearing a hat.
Yeah, that was it. I mean, he asked him three questions, none of them in any sort of a threatening manner. He was just being the media. He was being a journalist. And in this case, in Zanesville, Ohio, Ademo tells this guy, hey, you know, I'm the media. Because the other thing he wanted to do was to record in the courtroom. He wanted to go in and video record his friend's arraignment. And of course, court bailiff looks at him and tells him, you're not the media. And Ademo says, well, how do you know? You don't even know who I am. He says, well, where are your credentials? And, of course, you don't need to have credentials to be the media.
Right. And something that I've always wondered is, okay, like, where do you get credentials? How do you validate? Like, I can print up my own press badge. Does that give me credentials? Or do I have to go to some organization that you approve to get credentials?
In some places, printing up your own press badge is good enough. It just all depends. 855-450-FREE will tell you more about what's going on with Ademo Freeman currently in jail in Zanesville, Ohio. He's going to be there for several days. We'll tell you more coming up. Free Talk Live.
His hair was falling out in clumps Our golden retriever, Sundance, he scratched incessantly.
Mounds and mounds of fur all over the place. Our hairballs have hairballs.
Olive was suffering like a dog. She was itching, she was scratching, she was licking 24 hours a day.
Just chewing and chewing and chewing. So.
Scratching and biting.
Buddy, my Shih Tzu's itching problem, constantly licking his feet. It keeps me up at night.
And all it took was one container of Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
The shedding slowed down to almost none. The scratching went away after a few days.
Tons of energy. No more bad smells.
The shedding has stopped and the itching has stopped.
Sleep at night. Oh, let me do it again. Sleep at night. Get your dog some Dynavite.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Welcome back to more Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you get online, you should protect yourself, because nobody else is going to do it for you. You can, of course, employ certain tools to make protecting yourself more likely, to increase your privacy, and ProXPN is one of those tools you need to consider. In fact, you can consider it for free by going and downloading their software over at ProXPN.com/ FTL. It's Windows, Macintosh, iOS, Android, even Linux. So pretty much whatever it is you're using, you can use ProXPN to protect your internet connection. Your internet service provider right now is probably probably saving your surfing history, your search terms that you're entering. They may be keeping those logs for up to 5 years in some cases, and you can again stop that from happening by using ProXPN, because ProXPN encrypts your internet connection. So you keep your same internet service provider. ProXPN just sort of piggybacks on top. It's a virtual private network that uses your existing internet connection, but encrypts everything over it. So very handy tool. And again, try it for free by going to proxpn.com/FTL. And when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can connect to privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites, use code FTL50. That's FTL, the number 50, over at proxpn.com/FTL. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. proxpn.com/FTL, promo code FTL50. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. So back to the story here about our friend Adamo Freeman. He's sitting inside a jail cell right now and will not be seeing the outside of that jail cell for 5 days.
5 days?
Correct. For basically saying mother effer in the courtroom, not even in the courtroom, I don't think, in the court lobby. Essentially.
So he's not going to get out until Tuesday?
Well, I guess so. Why are you shocked? You look very shocked.
Well,
about that.
Today is Friday.
Right.
Why would they not do an arraignment on Monday?
Well, no, he won't be arraigned. This is contempt. I'm sorry if I didn't make that clear. Adamo was arrested for contempt of court today.
Okay, so because you were mentioning earlier about when you get arrested, you go for an arraignment.
Generally, that's true, unless you're getting arrested for contempt of court. In that case,
okay,
you go straight to jail, and you do not get out until the judge feels like letting you out, basically.
Okay, I was confused, and I was wondering why he would have to wait until Tuesday for an arraignment when there's a Monday before Tuesday,
right,
and the upcoming Monday is not a holiday.
So I don't know how it works in Ohio, but in New Hampshire, the only thing you get when you get arrested for contempt of court is something called the right of allocution. And that is where you are able to speak to the judge regarding your reasons for the behavior that was resulting in you being hit with the contempt of court charge.
Okay.
So basically the right of allocution is your opportunity to beg. And in my case, it got me out after 3 days when I was arrested for basically contempt of court 3 times, actually. I was charged thrice in one period, in one court hearing that I was at when I was many, many years ago in court for my tenants having a couch out in their lawn. I was arrested.
Oh, yeah, that's when you spent 90 days?
No. The sentence was 94, 93, or 94 days. But only 3 or 4 of those days were for the actual couch violation. The other 90 were 3 contempt of court violations at 30 days apiece. And so what ended up happening was when I was in jail, it was determined that I was supposed to have a right of allocution. The judge realized he made a mistake, and the judge was supposed to, in this case it was Judge Burke, that he was supposed to give me this so-called right of allocution,
okay,
before imposing the sentence, before sending me off to jail. So they actually had me back in for, I don't know if it was a video arraignment. I think it might have been a video arraignment. I forget. It's been a long time. This was 2008. And anyway, I got in front of the judge some way and used that opportunity to eat a little bit of crow and tell him that, you know, I'd be a good little boy in the future in the court as far as, you know, not talking out of turn and that sort of thing. Because that's basically what got me in hot water with Burke in the first place was the arraignment that I attended. I sort of tried some of the let's say sovereign tactics, if you will.
Yes, yes.
And he didn't like that very much. He didn't like me sort of talking back at him. And that is why I think he set me up for an arrest during the trial, because I got arrested within 6 seconds.
That's the one where you stood up and he said, have a seat.
Yeah.
And you tried to say something because you have to be standing when you talk to the court. Otherwise, the court can't hear you. And the court being the judge.
Right.
It's sort of like if you're at Boy Scouts or whatever, and you know, unless you have the talking stick, no one can hear what you're saying.
But in my case, I didn't sit
down
fast
enough. So unless you are standing up, they can't hear what you're saying, and you were trying to say something, and he said, have a seat, and you said, but I have a...
Have a seat.
You're under arrest.
Yeah, and then literally the bailiff was circling me for an arrest before I was even told I was under arrest. So they had intended on arresting me. It is the way it looked from the video.
Like, oh, certainly. Dude, I've seen the video several times.
He's grabbing his handcuffs before he's even been told that I'm under arrest. So I only say that just to kind of give you an example of contempt of court. Contempt is this criminal charge, but it's not really a criminal charge. There's criminal contempt, there's civil contempt. In this case, there's indirect criminal contempt and direct criminal contempt. And I believe that, and please, if you are an attorney type person or no more, and you know, you can correct me here. I believe the difference is direct criminal contempt is when you are within the judge's purview, when you are in the courtroom and the judge is in the courtroom. Then the judge can then say that, you know, you are in contempt and then have a bailiff arrest you, and that's direct criminal contempt. I believe indirect criminal contempt is when you are not within the judge's purview, but yet he goes ahead and charges you with contempt anyway. So if you, for instance, have an order from a judge, and the order from a judge says, you cannot do such and such, and you go out and you do such and such, and a cop catches you doing that, the cop can arrest you for contempt.
Right.
And then essentially there's a little bit more from what I understand of a hearing that would be involved in an indirect criminal contempt charge, because the judge didn't see it happen, so the judge would have to get the cop to testify about it in order to impose a sentence for that. In the case of direct criminal contempt, the judge can just go ahead and impose a sentence right there in the courtroom. All you get is that right of allocution where you can speak to the judge, which is what essentially Ademo did in this case when he was arrested earlier today in Zanesville, Ohio, because he said mother effer to a bailiff. Now, what's not clear, because we don't have video of him saying it, is whether he was actually in the courtroom at the time or whether he was outside of the courtroom. There's some videos with him interacting with this bailiff outside of the courtroom. And then, so you watch the initial interactions with this bailiff. Then the final video is Ademo in court talking to the judge.
Okay.
So it sort of jumps. So I don't know where he was at that time. I'm going to presume he was outside of the courtroom. But either way, so apparently what happened was the bailiff went and cried to the judge. And apparently what Ademo had said was, I sued the last mother effer who told me I couldn't record in a courtroom. Do you want to be sued? And then according to Dio,
he's threatening me.
Yeah, the bailiff then went to the judge and told him that Ademo called him a mother effer. The judge found Ademo in contempt and sentenced him to 10 days. After an apology, the judge relented and lowered the sentence to 5 days. So our friend Ademo in jail right now. You can go to coplock.org to learn more. We're coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
From media brainwashing to genetically modified food, forces of darkness are attempting to disempower you. Only you can battle against these forces by choosing mental and emotional wellness. Author Sean Morgan has spent years discovering the most effective methods for self-deprogramming and empowerment using ancient Eastern traditions and modern Western research. Now he's sharing the most powerful insights and practices to those suffering with low energy, low motivation, physical illness, anxiety, depression, and financial scarcity. Big Brother wants you to be docile, obedient, and fearful. By reading The Mastery of Change, you will develop your understanding of neural pattern interruptions, emotional energy cycles, and understand what it takes to break free from victimhood, illness, depression, and fear. Free to read online and available in hard copy and for all brands of e-readers for as little as $1, The Mastery of Change and its 30-day challenge gives you the steps to take now for massive transformation. Learn more at masteryofchange.com.
Free Talk Live's recent Bitcoin sale was a big success, so we decided to extend the 50% discount through April 17th.
Free Talk Live was the first ad venue in the world to accept Bitcoins for ads. We love the concept of a value-based digital currency that allows people to actually control their own money.
We introduced Roger Ver,
Bitcoin Jesus,
to Bitcoins, and here's what he said.
Free Talk Live is the premier voice for the peace and liberty Bitcoin will bring to the world. By broadcasting this message since 2011, Free Talk Live has been instrumental in creating the widespread adoption that we have today.
If you need some advertising for your business, website, or organization, and you want to save half off, send me an email right now, mark@freetalklive.com.
This is your chance to save 50% on national radio and podcast ads. Just pay with Bitcoin. Email mark@freetalklive.com. That's mark@freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency, and Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, and spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
We've made significant progress wiring the nation's schools for the internet, but we have to do more. Every child in America should have an internet-capable computer in their bedroom at home, preferably with a high-resolution webcam. I have been to children's chat rooms and have been shocked and disappointed to find they are frequently empty. Even when these youngsters do manage to find their way online, they lack the skills to do something as simple as pinpoint their location on Google Maps. I long for the day when someone can log onto the Nickelodeon Under 13 chat room and type, "Hey, any kids in here like to play Pokemon Mystery Dungeon? I have a Nintendo at my house," and be overwhelmed with instant messages. Then I'll know we're doing our job supporting technology in this country.
This is the Onion News Network.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Of course, you can dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. And the features on the site are free. Those other talk show hosts, many of them, they want to charge you for their websites. You can just go and enjoy over at freetalklive.com. And on Free Talk Live, we accept Bitcoin as well as a couple dozen other altcoins. If you want to contribute to the Bitcoin tip jar, you can go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com. Wait, what's that? You don't yet have any Bitcoin? Well, price has come down a little bit in the last few days, so maybe now's a good time to buy. Go and get your Bitcoin over at expresscoin.com. It's the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. They don't just sell Bitcoin. They also have Litecoin and Dogecoin. Go to expresscoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive, and they're a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, or wire transfer. They make it easy, and you can even do it from your smartphone with their app, expresscoin.com. The coupon code, by the way, that you should use is FTL, like Free Talk Live, which will get you up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice with no fee at all. So again, that's expresscoin.com with coupon code FTL. We're talking about our friend and sometime co-host, Ademo Freeman, who is basically on a nationwide tour. I don't know if he's officially calling it a tour, but that's essentially what he's doing. He's going from place to place, meeting up with folks from various different cop block divisions, if you will. There's sort of local groups for copblock.org all across the country.
Across the world, actually.
That's true. I don't know if he's going internationally on his tour, but he...
Probably not, because he's a felon.
Correct. So he is going about all around the United States, and he's been spending some time in Ohio recently, was in Zanesville today, and still is in Zanesville, and will be stuck in Zanesville for the next several days.
At least until Tuesday.
Yeah, considering that he is now under arrest and in jail for so-called contempt of court. Which is, and I didn't really explain this earlier, I kind of talked about the differences legally between indirect and direct criminal contempt. And in this case, I believe this was an instance of direct Well, it could have been indirect criminal contempt. I'm not real sure. I'm not sure where he was.
We don't know where he was standing.
Yeah, but either way, he was sentenced to 5 days after having said mother effer to one of the court bailiffs. And the bailiff thought he was calling him a mother effer. That's not, in point of fact, what he was doing. He, as he points out in one of the videos, which you can see over at copblock.org, in one of the videos where he's getting arrested, he points out that what he had said, in point of fact, was that he was referencing the last mother effer that that charged or that that he went after in court for arresting him for free speech, essentially. So he wasn't actually talking about that bailiff, although you could extrapolate from his sentence that he was suggesting that the bailiff was also a mother effer. But nonetheless, you should be able to call a bailiff a mother effer, especially if you are not actually in the courtroom in front of the judge. If you're just out in a court lobby, you should be able to say whatever you damn well please to whether it's a court bailiff, court employee, whether it's a police officer. And there have been cases, many of them, where the police have arrested somebody for doing something like flipping the bird at a cop or telling a cop F you. And those arrests have usually been overturned on a free speech ground.
Yes.
So,
but because this was not an arrest for, you know, what he said, this was an arrest for contempt of court. For
correct.
What he said, and you can't actually challenge contempt of court.
That's right. It's essentially an inherent power of the court, which is just crazy. It's just a ridiculous concept. You cannot challenge it. It cannot be appealed. There's really no evidentiary hearing whatsoever. There's, in the case of indirect criminal contempt, they'll have a cop testify, or in this case, the bailiff testify. He said, mother effer to me, judge! And then the judge will impose a sentence. You know, that's it. And then there's nothing you can do about it. You can try to apologize, which is what Ademo did in this case, and that got him half the sentence. So he was sentenced to 10 days, now down to 5 days as a result of that. But at this point, he could try to motion the court to reconsider, but beyond that, that's all he's got.
I don't think he could even do that because it's an arrest for contempt. It's not.
You can always motion the court. I mean, if you want to motion the court, you can motion the court. Whether the court will do anything about it is another question.
Okay, it takes 10 days for the court to act on a motion.
It can take 10 days. Yes, that's true. A lot of cases, the 10-day limit is to give the prosecutor time to respond. So I don't know if the court usually has a limit to respond to motions. It's usually just the prosecutor.
The court could take as long as they want. Like,
exactly,
they
what
could
I mean.
Wait 375 years to respond to a motion. This reminds me of a petition for redress that was filed in like 1789, I believe it was, here in New Hampshire, that the legislature finally got around to acting on about 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a petition for freedom from 19 or 20 people that were being held in slavery. And the court finally, in like 2012, 2013, or the legislature in New Hampshire in like 2013, finally got around to acting on this petition for redress from 1789. So, you know,
they've been busy.
These slaves got their freedom like 230 years after they died. But hey, they finally got their freedom, right?
Government. That's, you know, they just work so fast. So he's going to get out on Tuesday or whenever it's going to be in 5 days, and that at the very least it'll be over at that point. You know, he won't have another court date unless something happens within the jail, but presumably he won't have another court date, and hopefully, you know, he'll be able to get out of the area. But, you know, it was unfortunate that this happened, and one of the reasons why it happened was because he was alone. When you watch the videos, you can tell that Ademo is the only one there who is a cop block person. He was ostensibly there to support another cop blocker who was being arraigned, but that guy was in jail because the dude was arrested the day previous.
Okay.
And so he was likely being brought to, this is my understanding from assessing the situation from what level, little expertise I have about it. So Ademo wasn't with this other guy. The dude was probably being brought there from the jail in the jail van. And apparently there were no other cop blockers who were there with Ademo, which is a big no-no. Now, Ademo, you know, he's experienced. He's got a lot of time on the ground doing cop block, probably more than anyone else out there. Maybe, you know, maybe Pete Ayer, who's the other founder of CopBlock. These are two guys who've really cut their teeth in the area of standing up for people's rights and standing up for their own rights. And they're a couple of heroes of mine, no doubt about it. But it doesn't matter how much experience you have at doing this.
Right.
If you are alone, it's very easy to be outnumbered. In this case, there's one bailiff, and then there's another sort of plainclothes cop who's sort of following the bailiff around, acting as the bailiff's security. The plainclothes guy is a lot larger. In fact, at one point in one of the videos, there's about three videos that you can watch. There's a fourth one, but I don't know why they included it. It's just somebody's feet walking around. There's no audio. But in one of the videos, Ademo asks this other guy who's sort of following them around, "Are you a cop?" And he acknowledges that he is. And then he tells the cop that this man, the bailiff, in the blue shirt, just assaulted him. He laid his hands on him and like pushed him or something like that, pushed him out of a room. And he said, "Are you going to do anything about that assault?" And the cop denied that that was assault. Because it's
but
not,
had Ademo done that
to the
cop?
Yeah.
That would have been assault, probably attempted murder, and 27 other made-up charges.
Battery on a police officer, yeah. And so, anyway, the cop denied it, and so obviously Ademo points that out in the video, and then they go on. Ultimately, Ademo gets arrested. But the most important thing, I think, that to take away from this is please don't do this alone.
Right.
Please don't. I understand. And look, I speak from some experience here. I have done this alone. I mean, I get that once you're used to standing up for your rights, it's hard to do anything but that.
Right.
You want to exercise your rights, and you don't want to cower in front of the man, even if you're all by yourself. At least Ademo had his camera going. At least there's some footage of this over at copblock.org, and I've linked to it over at freekeen.com if you want to link directly to it. It's there. So at least there's footage, so he wasn't alone in that way, but having people there would likely have changed how this turned out.
And I'm not so sure.
We'll come back with more. It's Free Talk Live.
How strong is Allegra D?
It's my congestion's out of my way strong. Even in the park, playing with my dogs. Go fetch, Bosley.
Allegra D, a fast, non-drowsy antihistamine plus a powerful decongestant that starts relieving your toughest allergy symptoms in under 1 hour.
Allegra D is breathing free for 24 hours strong, even in the convertible.
Allegra D, strong relief for your allergy symptoms, guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but will hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
We're back now with more Free Talk Live. And of course, you can dial in toll free here, 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number, and we've got Skype. Our Skype username here is lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out to us there if you like as well. With you in studio tonight, it's Ian here.
And Daryl.
And, of course, hopefully the board op will fade out that intro music at some point, because it can be a little distracting if it keeps going on like that. So we've been talking about contempt of court. Our friend Adamo Freeman is in jail right now for this. It's an inherent power of the courts. And that means it can't be removed. I was wondering once, you know, well, could the legislature do something about this? Could the legislature go in there and gut the contempt of court powers?
The legislature claims that they don't have the authority to tell courts what they can or can't do. But yet they do that all the time. There are such things as mandatory minimum sentences.
Correct.
In which they are telling the court, this is the minimum amount of time that you can put somebody in jail. So they are telling the court what they can do what they can't do.
Right. There was also the jury nullification thing here in New Hampshire where the legislature passed this law that essentially said, the statute that essentially said that the courts had to allow people to have a jury nullification defense. I'm oversimplifying that because I don't want to get into deep detail about it. And ultimately, the courts decided to overturn that, essentially, to sort of gut that after the fact. And if essentially said that they might find it unconstitutional if it were to come about again in a more firmed up sort of manner.
Right.
But that was yet another example of the legislature trying to tell the courts what to do. In the case of contempt, however, and I can't say I've read the entire New Hampshire Constitution. I've read, you know, the Bill of Rights portion of it, but not really the rest of it. I don't know if it actually outlines contempt of court anywhere. I think it's just an inherent sort of power of the Western court system.
Right. It's part of, British common law.
Yeah.
And that, of course, is what American law is built on, except for the judicial system in Louisiana. And they are based on Napoleonic common law.
Hmm.
And one of the main differences between British common law and Napoleonic common law is that under British common law, you are presumed innocent until proven guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. Under Napoleonic, you are presumed guilty until you prove your innocence beyond a reasonable doubt.
These courts are getting more and more Napoleonic, it seems, over time.
Of course.
Let's go to Ralph. He's in Michigan. Of course, you can bring up anything you want. Ralph, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Daryl.
Well, let me just make a slight comment. I got a completely separate subject I want to talk about, but I want to make a slight comment on what you were talking about, the judicial system and the court system.
Sure.
I've been in it enough, and I told you about it that one time. But anyways, you know what? A court system is what the judge decides it is, period.
Right.
No, there is no rule of law. It's what the judge decides, and that's all there is to it. I mean, when the judge, the prosecutor, and your attorney all go out to dinner all the time or go to the same parties all the time, you know, it kind of makes you quake in your boots, you know, when you're standing there.
For sure.
Regardless of that, I just had a question. You were talking about discrimination the other day. And I ponder a lot, and I started pondering a situation that happened to me. And I found, you know, in the state of Michigan, if you're married, you cannot own a piece of property without your wife's name being on it.
Really?
But your wife can own all the property she wants without your name being on it. Now, why is that?
Really? You're saying the law is discriminatory against men.
Realtors. Well, you know, I've asked that question to realtors, and they gave me some answer. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, no, that just don't hold no water in that bucket. I mean, that dog needs to be shot. It don't bark. I've asked it to, the county assessors and treasurers and stuff, and the clerks, and they all came up with a whole different kind of crap answer. Mm. And I'm like, you know, you people need to get together and come up with one piece of crap that will fly or something, because I've gotten several answers and none of them really hold water. I said, but why? I said, isn't that discrimination against men? They said, here's what one county clerk told me. Well, you men take advantage of us women all the time.
Oh, wow.
I'm like, excuse me?
Ridiculous.
I'm like, excuse me?
How long has this law been on the books?
I have no idea how long it's been on the books, but there you go. That's the way it is, and that's all there is to it. And they said it ain't going to change. So, I'm like, okay, what a slap in the face. I'm not worried about it. I've been married.
So let me see if I'm following you here. What you're saying is, if you were to go out as a married man and purchase some property, and you alone were to sign on the dotted line, that your wife would then have access legally to that property. She would become the owner even though she wasn't involved in the transaction?
No, her name has to be on it.
Right, so what happens if her name is not?
You ain't going to get it, because I tried buying a piece of property.
Really?
I just wanted it in my name, this and that, you know, because I had, planned on doing certain things. Nothing illegal. Well, somewhat, you know what I'm saying? But anyways, the point is the realtor said, no, your wife's name has to be on it. We can't do this without her name.
How did they know you even had a wife?
How did they know? Well, they asked. She asked. Yeah, I'm married.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Who would have thought, you know?
Who would have thought to say no? Yeah, I see where you're coming from. That is frustrating. And Ralph, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's talk to Tom. He's in Nashua, New Hampshire. Tom, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Daryl.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago I called in and broke a news story on your program on Free Talk Live about a data breach that took place down in Florida. Now, I called up one time thinking it would be hilarious if they included everybody's Social Security numbers on a list of registered voters when they accidentally sent it out. That happened in Ohio in 2006. They accidentally included all the Social Security numbers.
Okay.
The Florida data breach, however, involved not Social Security numbers, but the confidential addresses from people who get to be not listed on the voter list for security reasons. And I broke that story on Free Talk Live on Friday the 27th. On Tuesday the 31st, the Florida Department of State put a press release on their website acknowledging that, yes, this happened. And you've got some county elections officials who are a little ticked off. Why didn't you tell us right away, you know, because this is putting people at risk, and now we should have been told right away and all of that. So
just to be clear, you are saying that in Florida, someone, I presume it's you, Tom, they requested a list of the voters, And in that list of voters, they included an address that was not supposed to be included. They included all the addresses that people gave them that they had told they would not reveal.
Yeah, 40-something thousand of them, and not just to me, but to 14 other orderers of the voter list that happened to order one that month, which was the March edition. And then they called everybody up and said, like, there's some
Now, here in New Hampshire, before you go on, here in New Hampshire, you can go down there and look at the voting list and see everybody's address. So it's not that way, or it's not supposed to be that way in Florida?
It's not supposed to be that way in Florida. I don't know if it has everybody's address on the voter list, or if there's some of them that are not on there for security reasons. You should check that out, like see if all the cops and judges are on there in New Hampshire. I know in Michigan, everybody is on there.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure everybody's on it in New Hampshire. So,
but you can't just go publish it on the internet either. There's restrictions on how it can be used for elections purposes in New Hampshire, but not in Florida. So what I'm getting at here is that the news story it's also hit some of the mainstream media. Some TV stations and newspapers are picking up on this story, and you might say that some of the county elections people are rather ticked off that they weren't told right away. And I bought the list, of course, because I run a website where I list all the Florida voters, and you can look them all up, and it's a reference thing, kind of like a phone book or anything else where you look up all kinds of public domain information. And I immediately knew when I got that, saw what the issue was. I don't want to put that on my website. So they're just lucky, though, you know. It would have been a bigger mess if I had opted to share that with everybody.
Tom, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. What's the website for the voters? I'm sorry, you cut out there. One more time.
FLvoters.com.
All right, thanks for the call tonight. There's more coming up here in moments on Free Talk Live.
Indefinite extension of the human lifespan is coming. But is it coming soon enough for you and me? That's the $80,000 question. I say $80,000 because that's what it costs to have your head cryonically frozen by Alcor. I've committed to do it. I got a life insurance policy, and I made them the beneficiaries. Bam, my best shot at living forever. Interested? Contact them at alcor.org. ALCOR.ORG. Mention my name, and I get a free year of membership.
The results are in. For the treatment of nasal allergy symptoms, nothing is more effective than Nasacort. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour is prescription-strength medicine that's scent and alcohol-free with no harsh taste. It's non-addictive and provides 24-hour relief of the worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, with no prescription needed. And in a recent clinical study with Nasacort going nose-to-nose with Flonase, more people prefer Nasacort. For more information, visit Nasacort.com. Nasacort. Use as directed.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, April 10th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.47 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,203 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports President Obama went to Panama last night for an historic meeting with his Cuban counterpart, Raul Castro, on the sidelines of a major regional summit. Looming large in the meeting is the ongoing review of Cuba's inclusion on U.S. list of international sponsors of terrorism, with President Obama saying he will soon decide on the issue. Obama offered an upbeat assessment on the likely removal of Cuba from the list, saying the U.S. would need strong evidence to support putting the nations on the list, which historically has not been the case. The U.S. traditionally has used terror listings to bludgeon international rivals. There was never much justification for Cuba to be on the list beyond long-standing U.S. acrimony towards them. Even with the removal seemingly imminent, U.S. officials are indicating that they're holding off while trying to get certain guarantees from Cuba about their access to diplomatic facilities. This underscores the reality that the terror list has little to do with terrorism, and Cuba's presence or removal from the list will have nothing to do with terrorism. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Coinbase has more than 1 million consumer wallets and is trusted by over 25,000 merchants, including Overstock.com, Khan Academy, Reddit, and of course, FPP. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports a supervisor in the U.S. Secret Service has been placed on administrative leave following an incident last week in which the official allegedly made an unwanted sexual advance at the agency's Washington, D.C. headquarters. Senior Supervisor Xavier Morales is accused of making the advance on a female subordinate, according to ABC News and The Washington Post. The Secret Service, an agency under the oversight of the Department of Homeland Security, did not initially comment on the matter. However, the agency's director later made a statement to the Post. The Homeland Security Inspector General's office is handling the investigation, along with the D.C. Metro Police Department's Sex Crimes Unit. Authorities said Morales had been placed on leave and his security clearances have been suspended pending the outcome of an investigation. Two sources close to the investigation said in the Post report that Morales inappropriately grabbed the female subordinate on March 31st following a party at a downtown restaurant. The incident was reported on April 2nd and several interviews were conducted that day. A gathering at a restaurant celebrated Morales' new assignment to head the agency's field office in Louisville, Kentucky. He was scheduled to take the helm in Louisville this week. It is not clear whether the investigation will affect that assignment. The unnamed female employee reportedly told investigators that Morales, who is married to a Secret Service agent, admitted at the restaurant that he had feelings for her and sought a sexual relationship. His advances supposedly turned physical when the two returned to the agency's headquarters, and the woman said she fended him off until he relented.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a South Carolina police officer has been fired after being charged with murder for shooting a man in the back as he fled, but questions remained on Wednesday about some details of the killing that was filmed by a witness. The shooting occurred on Saturday in North Charleston, but it gained national media attention on Tuesday when the video became public. The mayor said that Michael Slager has been fired, but said the city would cover insurance for his family until his wife gives birth. She is currently 8 months pregnant. Walter Scott had been stopped by police for a broken taillight on his vehicle. According to legal experts, the city of North Charleston, which has a 2015 budget of $105.6 million, about one-third of which goes to the police department, could end up paying out a significant amount to Scott's family. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A new study released this week based on extensive psychological profiling of some of the world's most notorious serial murderers found that their homicidal instincts can be traced to a single incident in childhood when they were denied a toy that they really wanted.
Nearly all violent serial offenders, from John Wayne Gacy and Jeffrey Dahmer to the DC snipers, exhibited their first violent impulses shortly after being told as children that a video game was too expensive, or that they had a perfectly good Lego set at home and they could make do with that.
Researchers found that an isolated occurrence in which a parent refuses to buy a stuffed animal or candy bar for their child can immediately trigger the development of sociopathic tendencies.
I was in such a blind rage that I went up to my room, sawed the heads off all my action figures, and ejaculated into their body cavities.
This was most notably the case with Jeffrey Dahmer, who began decapitating stray dogs and placing their heads on spikes shortly after being denied an Etch-a-Sketch.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio at 855-450-FREE. That's a toll-free number, 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. The features are free, so enjoy those on us. Once again, freetalklive.com. Coming up, Daryl, you'll be telling us about nanosatellites.
Yes.
Bitcoin nanosatellites.
Yes.
And it sounds pretty fascinating. I definitely want to know more. But also, in other news, the Washington Post is reporting on the National Security Agency, which, of course, has been in the news more often than they would have liked, I imagine, within the last couple of years, since the Edward Snowden revelations came out almost 2 years ago. It was in the summertime of 2013, I believe, when that information hit.
Yes.
And, of course, Edward Snowden is still on the run, essentially living in Moscow under some level of asylum granted to him by the Russian government. And it was Edward Snowden who revealed all kinds of interesting information about the NSA and how often they and how often they're spying and how deep their ability to spy can actually penetrate, which is pretty much anything. If they've got your IP address or your email address, they can watch everything you do on your computer, according to at least one of the revelations from Edward Snowden. And there were many more that obviously I can't go over here for the sake of brevity. But now the NSA's back in the news. For months, federal law enforcement agencies and industry have been deadlocked on a highly contentious issue. Should tech companies be obligated to guarantee the U.S. government access to encrypted data on smartphones and other digital devices? And is that even possible without compromising the security of so-called law-abiding customers? Recently, the head of the National Security Agency provided a rare hint of what some U.S. officials think might be a technical solution. Why not, said Admiral Michael S. Rogers, require technology companies to create a digital key that could open any smartphone or other locked device to obtain text messages or photos, but divide the key into pieces so that no one person or agency alone could decide to use it. Rogers says, "I don't want a back door," the director of the nation's top electronic spy agency said during a speech at Princeton University, using a tech industry term for covert measures to bypass device security. He says, "I want a front door, and I want the front door to have multiple locks, big locks," he says. Law enforcement and intelligence officials have been warning that the growing use of encryption could seriously hinder criminal and national security investigations. But the White House, which is preparing a report for President Obama on the issue, is still weighing a range of options, including whether authorities have other ways to get the data they need rather than compel companies through regulatory or legislative action. And, you know, it's certainly not uncommon for them to compel companies to do things for them, so I don't see why they're even bothering to try to avoid it here. Is it just that they want to create the belief in the public that they somehow care about, you know, not messing with these tech companies? And
we don't want to be seen as intervening in these tech companies to directly tell them to do this stuff to allow us to spy on them, because that would make us look bad.
Yeah.
Because we just want to, you know, tell people that, no, we're only spying on the bad guys. And then they're secretly telling the tech companies, okay, here's the back door that you need to put in so that we can spy on your people.
Yeah, and they could also, and you're right, they don't want to be seen. There is, to some extent, a PR campaign going on here. And they will ultimately do what they need to, which is to force these companies to do whatever. And if you, maybe you're right, Daryl, maybe they're forcing them quietly, coercively, and telling them, hey, you can't
tell
anyone.
That's the claim that I've heard from several places anyway.
The same, and I imagine they're asking, or they're telling them, you better keep it quiet too, right?
Like, yes.
You can't talk about this. So that's one of the reasons why I don't think you can really trust Google and Apple, for instance, with their supposed phone-wide encryption that they're offering. I mean, I understand that it's believed that it's good, but I wouldn't trust it. I would much more likely trust a third-party application than one of these mega corporations, some sort of an open-source movement like TrueCrypt, for instance, or there's a new one out called VeraCrypt, I believe, V-E-R-A, which is an update on TrueCrypt's technology. We can talk a little bit more about TrueCrypt here in a moment. But continuing the story from the Washington Post, the task is not easy. Those taking part in the debate have polarized views, with advocates of default commercial encryption finding little common ground with government officials who see increasing peril as the technology becomes widespread on mobile phones and on text messaging apps. The Apple catalyzed the public debate in September when they announced that one of the world's most popular smartphones would now come equipped with a unique digital key that can be used only by its owner. If presented with a warrant, Apple could no longer unlock an iPhone that runs its latest operating system. Which I think, if that's true, then I think that's good news. And that was Apple was doing that in response to, is my understanding at least, they were doing that in response to the Edward Snowden revelations, which have resulted in a newfound desire for privacy, at least among people in the tech world.
Right.
As we discovered earlier this week, there are a lot of people in the United States who don't have a clue who Edward Snowden is. They don't know a thing about, you know, Ed Snowden and his revelations about the NSA. Maybe they don't like the idea of the government having pictures of their genitals, but they don't really know the details about how they could have those pictures.
Oh, there are some people that they probably don't care that people in the government have pictures of their genitals.
I suspect you're right about that, but the reason I brought that up was it was in the John Oliver presentation where the John Oliver actually got an interview with Ed Snowden.
I've still yet to actually have the time to watch that interview.
Yeah, I haven't seen it yet either, but we did discuss it earlier this week, and I think it was Mark who had seen it. And, basically, the people that they talked to on the streets didn't have any idea who Ed Snowden was. But they did not like the idea of the government having access to their personal photos. They just didn't know about it. They didn't know that they could, I guess. It's my understanding of it. If you've seen it and you want to, you know, clarify that, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. But Apple jumped on board with this, and then it was Google that announced shortly thereafter that they were also doing the same thing, that their phones would ship essentially with encryption enabled, is my understanding. So there's that. Hailed as a win for consumer privacy and security, the development has dismayed law enforcement officials who say it threatens what they describe as a centuries-old social compact in which the government, with a warrant based on probable cause, may seize evidence relevant to criminal investigations. Why, we're used to doing whatever it is we want to do. How dare these companies get in our way? How dare these companies empower the individual to protect their privacy? We are the government, and we should be able to govern every aspect of your life, every little bit of data. We should have access to it. Who do these companies think they are flummoxing us like that?
I'm still trying to, and you know, don't get me wrong, I am in no way one of these constitutionalists that think that, you know, words written on paper a couple hundred years ago were going to protect me, but I'm still trying to figure out how any of what the NSA does fits within the Fourth Amendment that says that the right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated, and no warrant shall be issued but upon probable cause. How does any of what they do fit within that?
How does any of pretty much anything the government does fit within the Constitution? I mean, they're so far out of bounds today. You know, they're not just violating the Fourth Amendment. They're violating all of the basic Bill of Rights.
All right, of them. But them trying to read your email does not violate the First, Second, Third, Fifth, or Eighth Amendment. Like, those are directly in violation of the Fourth Amendment.
Right.
Because my computer is one of my effects. You know, it could be argued that it's digital paper because, you know, who really uses physical paper anymore?
Well, we've got some in front of us here.
We do. But, you know, your average person, all they do is use a computer screen. Like, they're not jotting down notes every day.
Okay.
So, you know, the computer is basically the notepad of the 21st century. If that makes any sense.
Yeah, absolutely. I want to come back and discuss this further. Of course, you're welcome to add your thoughts in toll-free. 855-450-FREE is the number. We're talking about privacy, and you've got to protect your privacy. You've got to be the one who takes responsibility for it. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country, with a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers. How can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free. Bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE is the number, 855-450-3733. The government's mad. They're mad about all this encryption. They want access, and they want it to everything. Every bit of data you have, they want to be able to know. They want to be able to dig around. They want it to be able to copy it and you know, learn everything about you. And the encryption techniques out there are, at this point, obviously unbreakable by the government. Otherwise, they wouldn't be crowing so loud about this. You know, they can't get into this stuff. And now they're saying they want to force, perhaps, Apple or Google or other equipment manufacturers who are now shipping, in some cases, cell phones that have encryption built into the operating system, basically whole phone encryption, essentially. And they want to, you know, they're talking about options as far as how they can stop that from happening. They want to put in what the NSA head is now saying is it's not a back door he wants. He wants a front door with multiple locks and big locks.
I don't understand what he means by multiple locks, because they want to be able to get in.
That's correct.
Maybe it's they don't want hackers to be able to get in, so we put the locks on, and then the hackers can't get in, but we can?
It's just a smokescreen, in my opinion, what they're talking about here, Daryl. He said he wants to divide the key into pieces so that no one person or agency alone could decide to use it. Well, so what? So what if no one agency could decide to use it? So does that mean that the law enforcement agency that wants to read your phone then just has to go to Apple and says, all right, give us the other piece of the key. We need to get into this guy's phone. And then Apple, of course, hands it right over. I mean, this is just the illusion that
right,
there would be some
kind of check.
Because
if you don't hand over the key, then bad things will happen to you.
You as the technology company operative. Yeah.
So it sounds like maybe they want one of these multi-sig sort of things to where Homeland Security has a key, the NSA has a key, yeah, and the president has a key, and then you also have the tech company with the key.
Right.
And so then they can just, like, bypass the tech company because, we've got three of the four keys, so screw you.
Yeah, the idea that this multi-key thing would somehow provide any kind of layer of prevention of them accessing your data is just absolutely ridiculous, and like I said, it's nothing more than a smokescreen or a distraction. You know, we are talking about smartphones, and one of the worst parts about a smartphone is that they just drain on the battery.
Yes.
They just, you know, even with a relatively moderate amount of use, your battery might be dead before your business day is done. And certainly if you're out camping or, you know, you're in an airport, you're stuck in an airport, you're in places where you can't easily get to a wall to charge your phone. Maybe you don't have the phone adapter with you. There's all kinds of circumstances where a dead phone can be very, very inconvenient and in some cases could be life-threatening. So if you've got the Pocket Power Plus, well, you've solved that problem because the Pocket Power Plus is a breakthrough in portable power technology. In fact, so powerful, in some circumstances, it can actually jump start a car. You can literally put it in your pocket or leave it in your glove box for some difficult times, or just, you know, bring it with you every day in your briefcase. Personally, I think that'd be the smartest move. That way you've got it with you, you know, wherever it is that you are, whether you're in your car, or you're at the office, or, you know, on a train or something like that. It can run electronic devices for hours, even days, if you need to. And it can deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power. Plus, comes with a full accessory pack that has most of the adapters you might possibly need to charge your various devices, including your laptop. And it even includes the jumper cables. So go and learn more at PocketPowerPlus9.com. And Free Talk Live listeners can get the Pocket Power Plus for half off by going to PocketPowerPlus9.com, and you can use coupon code FTL to save even more at PocketPowerPlus9.com. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. We're talking about the Washington Post story here on the NSA wanting to have what they call a front door with multiple locks, big locks, he says. It's not a back door. We're not just forcing these technology companies to give us access to... Oh, yeah, that's exactly what they want to do. They want to force technology companies to essentially give them access to their new encryption schemes. Now, according to the story here, the task is not easy, as there are now even more encrypted apps becoming available, even for text messaging, which, by the way, I recommend Text Secure. It's a pretty cool little app. According to the story here, the Apple was the first to do this, hailed as a win for privacy and security. The development has dismayed law enforcement officials. We're concerned. What we're concerned about is the technology risks, bringing the country to a point where the smartphone owner alone, who may be a criminal or terrorist, has control of the data, said Deputy Assistant Attorney General David Bitkauer at a recent panel on encryption hosted by the nonprofit Congressional Internet Caucus Advisory Committee. That, he said, has not been the standard American principle for the last couple of hundred years. Tech industry officials...
I didn't realize that they had smartphones in the statutes for the last couple hundred years.
Or encrypted, or encryption for that matter.
Yeah.
Tech industry officials and privacy advocates take a different view. Mark Zwillinger, an attorney for tech companies on encryption-related matters and a former Justice Department official, says, quote, I don't believe that law enforcement has an absolute right to gain access to every way in which people may choose to communicate. And further, he says, I don't think our founding fathers would think so either. The fact that the Constitution offers a process for obtaining a search warrant where there is probable cause is not support for the notion that it should be illegal to make an unbreakable lock. These are two distinct concepts. Now, of course, what the courts will end up saying about all this is another question. The increasing use of encrypted storage extends well beyond the iPhone or the similar option that Google is now offering, though not by default. So I was wrong about that. It's not on turned on by default. You have to turn it on, but it's available on its new versions of its Android operating system. Windows and Apple offer simple settings to encrypt the contents of personal computers, and several cloud storage companies encrypt the data they host with keys known only to their customers. And this is because that's what people are demanding. People are demanding the ability to be more private online for whatever the reason. Who knows what someone's motivation for privacy is? It could simply be that, you know, they don't want their friends to see their nudie pics that they've taken. Or maybe they're business secrets. Maybe they don't want a competitor to get access to the Kentucky Fried Chicken Colonel's recipe or the recipe for Pepsi. You know what I mean? There's these business secrets that are also very, very important. So everybody has things they want to not reveal to the entire world, including the government, by the way.
But at the same time, there are a lot of people that they're revealing personal data to everybody without realizing that they're revealing it to everybody.
Mm-hmm. When, like by posting things on Facebook or whatever?
And having your settings set to public
without
on Facebook.
Without really following what that is, without even knowing what the little globe next to your post means.
I forget who it was that did this video. It was, I believe, the EFF. But it might have been some other privacy advocate group where they went out and they had somebody in a van and they had somebody with a camera and microphone and they were doing like a man on the street sort of thing. Like, what's your name? Where are you from? The person in the van was pulling up the people's Facebooks and then talking to the man with the microphone.
And giving him info.
And he would say, oh, did you go to such and so high school? You graduated in this year? And they're like,
wow,
how do you know
you're
this?
Psychic. I've seen one of them like that. I also saw another one which was really sharp where they were using, I think it was Instagram, and they were getting information about people without them even answering a question. And I'll tell you how they did that here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just 3 of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
Phone records, financial and location data, Prism, Tempora, X-Keyscore, Boundless Informant. Hey, y'all, Scott Horton here for offnow.org. Now, here's the deal. Due to the Snowden revelations, we have a great opportunity for a short period of time to get some real rollback of the national surveillance state. Now, they're already trying to tire us by introducing fake reforms in the Congress. And the courts, they betrayed their sworn oaths to the Constitution and Bill of Rights again and again, and can in no way be trusted to stop the abuses for us. We've got to do it ourselves. How? We nullify it at the state level. It's still not easy, but the Off Now project of the 10th Amendment Center has gotten off to a great start. I mean it. There's real reason to be optimistic here. They've gotten their model legislation introduced all over the place, in state after state. I've lost count, more than a dozen. You're always wondering, yeah, but what can we do? Here's something. Something important. Something that can work if we do the work. Get started cutting off the NSA support in your state. Go to offnow.org.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You dial in toll free. Bring up whatever you'd like. 855-450-FREE. Maybe you believe the government should have access to every little bit of data that they would like to access, which, of course, is all of the bits. They want access to all of them. And that's what we're talking about here with the Washington Post story about how they are debating in the federal government right now, to some extent the executive branch, trying to debate about how to approach Google and Apple and see if they can get an access pathway into their encrypted systems. For instance, they're shipping phones now where you can easily encrypt the entire phone, and the government is making it look like they can't get into that. They're publicly complaining about this and saying that something must be done. They're just trying to figure out how to do it without looking like total tyrants. And, you know, they're going to look bad, I think, anyway they slice
it. Give them time, and they won't care about looking like total tyrants.
That's true. So we want to continue the story here in a moment. Also want to let you know how to get some gold and silver pieces from Midas Resources. You can visit silver.freetalklive.com. They've got hand-picked gold and silver pieces, and Midas Resources has been doing this for a long time. Whether you want your gold or silver as a hedge against inflation, investment, or a barter currency, they can help you out over at silver.freetalklive.com, and you can call them toll-free, 877-857-9938. That's 877-857-9938. And again, that's silver.freetalklive.com. According to the Washington Post, the Obama administration says they're not looking to weaken the security. They just want access. President Obama said in an interview with tech outlet Recode in February, quote, "There's no scenario in which we don't want really strong encryption. I lean probably further in the direction of strong encryption than do some inside of law enforcement. But I'm sympathetic to law enforcement because I know the kind of pressure they're under to keep us safe. And it's not as black and white as it's sometimes portrayed." So the idea, of course, is that, well, if they don't have access to everyone's phone whenever they want it, then the terrorists will win. So, of course, you want to give up your privacy, right? Does that right. convince you? Are you convinced? 855-450-FREE. You can also bring up anything that's on your mind. We've got Cyrus on the line via Skype. You're on Free Talk Live, Cyrus.
Hey, Ian, I'm so sorry that I'm going a little off topic here.
That's
but
okay. Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything, as we say repeatedly.
Thank you, and I appreciate that. You know, I hear a lot of guys talking and women sometimes about the blood moon, and I, you know, that absolutely drives me crazy. I don't know anything about it. I think it's complete nonsense. But I was talking to my kids the other day, and it was more of an exercise in philosophy. And if I were a betting man, this would probably not carry much water. But I just kind of wanted to get your opinion, someone who actually thinks outside the box, is pretty open-minded, despite being very principled. I was breaking the thought of the idea of the moon down to the five senses. Sight, hearing, touch, taste, feel. The only one that's actually really that I can verify or say personally that I can stand behind is sight. Everything else is hearsay through sources and parties that I've never actually had a conversation with. I've never been able to verify. And it seems like it's almost like 15 levels out or so. And I just wanted to know your opinion of that. And again, I'm not saying that the moon's fake, but it's just it's almost like an exercise that, you know, we just take these things for granted and it's just so ingrained in our culture. And I just kind of wanted to know your opinion of that.
Hold on. I want to make sure that I understood something correctly. You said the only one of your senses that you trust is sight?
No. The only one that I can verify personally is sight. I cannot hear the moon. I cannot touch the moon. I cannot taste the moon. And I cannot feel the moon.
Oh, okay. I was thinking that you meant, in general, the only one of your senses that you trusted was sight. And I was going to try to debunk that because you can't always believe what you see, because sometimes you see things that you think you see one thing, but it's something else.
Or other people see them differently, like colorblindedness, for instance.
Right. And even long before the whole debacle of what color is the dress, I saw a video where it said, can you really believe what you see? And the guy doing the video, he showed a still photo for 30 seconds. And gradually throughout the video, the color of the jacket that the man in the picture was wearing changed colors.
Mm-hmm.
But it was such a gradual change from the beginning to the end that you didn't notice.
Huh.
But then at the end, he says, if you were asked by a police officer to describe this person, could you do it? And then he showed the two pictures and said, which one of these did you think you've been looking at the whole time? And you realize, oh, wait, this is the one that I saw at the beginning, and this is what it was at the end. So your eyes do play tricks on you. But as far as the moon goes, like I've heard theories that, you know, the moon is a really old satellite that was
really?
Made. Or wait, no, that's one of the Martian moons that's hollow. Phobos, one of the Martian moons is hollow. Okay. So there's a claim that it's some sort of alien satellite. There's, you know, claims that, you
maybe
know,
the NSA has an office in there.
Who knows? There's claims that, you know, the moon around Earth has, you know, like alien life living deep in the middle and it's hollow and this and that. And I don't really know. That. Like, yeah. I don't know. Maybe it is. Maybe it's not. Maybe there isn't a moon. I don't know. Like, I see the thing.
Yeah. I mean, the exercise seems a little bit silly. I mean, it seems a little pointless, right? Because you won't ever be able to verify it. But in order to go about living in the real world, you sort of have to accept what other people say, right? Like these supposed experts who have ostensibly spent their lives studying matters of space, they have a few things to say about the moon. And there's, of course, evidence that people have actually landed on the moon. So some people have ostensibly touched the moon, but obviously you have to believe their claims. But that's true about a lot of things in life. You have to believe all kinds of scientists' claims about a variety of different subjects, whether it's the food that you eat, whether it's, you know, the trees that are growing nearby you. And, you know, there's all kinds of claims that are made that you'll never personally be able to verify. You just sort of have to accept certain experts as believable. And, of course, if you really want to go off into, you know, la-la land, then you can't really, as you pointed out, Daryl, you can't trust your own sight. You can't trust any of your senses, ultimately, because right. You can't prove that you're here. It seems apparent that you're here, but it all could be a computer simulation, and there's no way to really prove otherwise.
Or I've often thought this, that maybe all of existence that as we know it is really just the dream of like some really big giant in another galaxy.
That's similar to, I don't know if you've ever heard of the bubble in a woman's bathtub theory.
What? I have never heard such a thing.
I'll try to paraphrase. I know I'm going a little bit off topic here and it's a little crazy, but at least it's better than the blood moon. But the idea is that, you know, our universe is actually an atom in a woman's bathtub and a bubble. A bubble bath.
Okay.
And again, I'm not saying that's the truth or I believe that. I'm just saying it's, you know, you can get really, you know, philosophical about this and a little crazy.
Sure.
But again, you know, the more that we, you know, just kind of accept these things, the more, you know, I just start to question everything. You know, it's like I question the government. I question, you know, authority. I question everything. And then, you know, I'm looking at the moon one day. I bought a telescope from Goodwill for $3 and it worked. And I'm thinking, you know, what am I looking at? This is the only way I can verify this. And I've never talked to anybody who's actually been on the moon, or I've never talked to anyone who's touched it. I've never touched it, smelled it, tasted it. It's just I can see it. And, you know, again, if I was a betting man, yeah, okay, there's a moon. Let's not be crazy here.
I wonder what the moon would taste like.
Cheese, of course. Thanks for the call, Cyrus. Appreciate it. The toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We can get esoteric here. It's fine. You can share your thoughts on, you know, reality. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live. More on the way. And plus more on the security thing.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
From media brainwashing to genetically modified food, forces of darkness are attempting to disempower you.
Only you can battle against these forces by choosing mental and emotional wellness. Author Sean Morgan has spent years discovering the most effective methods for self-deprogramming and empowerment using ancient Eastern traditions and modern Western research. Now he's sharing the most powerful insights and practices to those suffering with low energy, low motivation, physical illness, anxiety, depression, and financial scarcity. Big Brother wants you to be docile, obedient, and fearful. By reading The Mastery of Change, you will develop your understanding of neural pattern interruptions, emotional energy cycles, and understand what it takes to break free from victimhood, illness, depression, and fear. Free to read online and available in hard copy and for all brands of e-readers for as little as $1, The Mastery of Change and its 30-day challenge gives you the steps to take now for massive transformation. Learn more at masteryofchange.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. LRN.fm needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You are able to call in and bring up anything that you want. I want to talk to you about privacy tonight. You're welcome to bring up, again, whatever's on your mind. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype. The Skype username here is lrn.fm. Ian and Daryl in the studio. Daryl, you are the host of a few different shows. One of them is a seven-day-a-week newscast.
Yes.
What's that called?
That is FPP Radio News. It's a five-minute daily newscast that I have done 7 days a week for, I believe, about 428 consecutive days. Well,
wow.
Actually, there's a three-day gap in there, and those are 3 days that I was in jail and not able to find anyone to record the newscast, but the newscast has been produced, aside from those 3 days, every day of the week since February 3rd of last year.
That's an incredible level of dedication, and you do a great job with it, and it's 7 days a week. So fppradio.com is where you can get that, as well as your other show, which is thrice weekly, Peace, Love, Liberty Radio, and a weekly five-minute opinion piece as well.
Yes, that is the FPP Freedom Minutes. That is the longest running of the three, And I've been doing that for about 3.5 years. It'll be 4 years in August.
Wow. Drop on by fppradio.com to get lots more. Daryl, and also fpp.cc is his other website with articles and newspapers and other stuff for free. Oh, and books. You can buy books.
Yes.
So fppradio.com and fpp.cc. As we continue here, let's go to Dave. He's in Nevada on Skype. Hello, Dave.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, what's on your mind?
So earlier, you guys have been talking about some contempt of court stuff and courts in general. So I had two things I wanted to bring up.
Sure.
One, if it's all right, I have this really short clip of in a courtroom where you have a judge who basically gives a woman a year who kind of just everything she says, he throws out days, and it ends up being a year in jail. And
wow.
It's a pretty short clip. If I could just play that,
you can
real
play
quick.
It. Okay, yeah. If you've got the audio system to do that,
yeah. And I got my mixer and everything set up. So the audio quality of the clip itself isn't that great, but I mean, playing through what it's playing through, it's good enough.
And it is radio friendly, correct?
Yeah, yeah. She does curse, but it's bleeped out.
All right, go for it.
Good morning, Ms. Burks.
Good morning.
You're charged with assault. That's a misdemeanor one, carries a possible fine of $1,000 and/or 6 months in jail. Domestic violence is also a misdemeanor one and carries a possible fine of $1,000 and/or 6 months in jail. You have three pleas available to you today: guilty, not guilty, and no contest. You also have the right to a lawyer, and if you can't afford them, what plea would you enter?
Not guilty.
Court will accept your plea of not guilty. I'm going to assign your case to one of the courtrooms. All right, Ms. Burks. On the domestic violence, I'm going to set a $7,500 cash or surety bond. That bond is conditioned on no contact with Cedric McRae. On the assault, I'm going to set a $7,500 cash or surety bond. That bond is conditioned on no contact with Tiffany Castro. No contact means you can't call him, you can't write him, you can't text him, you can't email him. Can't leave a message on some social media. You can't go visit him. If you go someplace and either Mr. McRae or Ms. Castro's there, you have to leave. If you're someplace, even though you may have arrived first and one of them shows up, you still have to leave.
Wow. So you're going to tell me I can't go home?
I'm telling you, you can't go home. If you live with... If you live with Mr. McRae, you cannot return to that residence.
Oh, but how are you just going to tell me I can't go home, though?
What?
How you gonna tell me I can't go to my house?
I just did.
Well, I bet I do.
Well, then you're in contempt, young lady, and you've got 30 days. So you're not going. You're not what?
Whoa!
Get back! Get back!
You just said I got 30 days.
Get back! That's another 30 days. That's 60 days.
So what?
90 days.
So?
120 days.
Okay, and.
180 days.
Oh,
please, quiet.
Get off me. Get your hands off me, man.
Come on.
What else you got to say?
Oh, nothing. We'll talk in 6 months when you're ready to come back for your case.
Wow.
Not as sorry as she's going to be.
I ain't there. They got something here. I got money.
That's 200 days.
Oh, God.
You got anything else to say, Ms. Burks?
You.
That's 300 days.
This lady don't give a flip.
So, I mean... And I had got that on YouTube, and I actually played a lot on my show, just because it's an example of how the judges can do whatever they want.
Anything.
And I have, this is not the only one as well. So you see these judges really just throwing out days like it's nothing because they feel disrespected and like, this is my court and you can't talk back to me. And one of the things I wanted to bring up, and I'm sure you guys are familiar with this, but the Mark Schmitter case, and just for people who aren't familiar, Mark is from Orlando. He's heavily involved in jury nullification.
That's right, yeah.
And still is. And he was handing out flyers during the Casey Anthony case. And what had happened was the judge issued orders that you cannot hand these out to potential jurors and you can't hand them out in a certain area of the courtroom. And he did this within his court, not that Mark was even in. So he issued an order within his court that you have to follow that you don't even know about. Mark ended up going to jail for 6 months over this. So it's not even just pertaining to being in the court. I mean, it's bad enough that they give orders. You know, a lot of times they'll say, you know, gag orders. And if you violate them, you're contempt of court. But at least they're telling that specific person. In this case, it's just, okay, well, you might not even know about this, but we're going to send you to 6 months in jail. And I mean, Mark is an older guy. I don't think he's ever been in any trouble except, you know, for civil disobedience and things like that. And yeah, he ended up spending 6 months in jail. So yeah, I don't think people realize how the power that judges have and what they can do. And you had mentioned earlier, and I saw the video of this, in one of your cases where you didn't sit down fast enough and you got found in contempt of court.
Sure. We've had people arrested for HAT. There's an order that applies right now to the courthouse here in Keene where you cannot go into the courthouse and record video. And they will let you record in the courtroom, but if they see you recording video outside of the courtroom, there's a chance they could arrest you for contempt for that.
They also have it written in that you cannot distribute literature.
That's right.
And they have that written in such a broad manner that includes handing a piece of paper to the bailiff.
Or them handing a piece of paper to you.
Right. Because they do not exempt official court business from the distribution of literature.
They just won't enforce on
them. They won't enforce it on them. But they have written this in such a poor manner to where it includes anything.
Yep.
If I write down a note, like, you know, we're in court, I'm trying to be a good little boy and be quiet, so I jot something down on a piece of paper and then hand it to Ian asking, do you want to get breakfast after court? Then I am in violation of the distribution of literature.
Well, you had the Pete Ayer case, right, where he got found in contempt for wearing a hat.
That's right.
And he was dragged across. There's the video where they dragged him across the street. And it reminds me like of high school where, you know, you couldn't wear a hat or you got detention. But that has nothing to do with anything other than teaching discipline and saying you have to obey.
Yes, I mean, who cares if somebody wears a hat in
the courtroom?
And the funny thing is with the Pete arrest, not 2 minutes after Pete got dragged out of the courtroom, a police officer walked into the court wearing a hat.
That's true.
Well, it's do what I say, not what I do.
Exactly. Dave, any other thoughts you want to share?
Just briefly, I don't know if you still have a couple minutes. I wanted to bring up, and I don't know if this is something you guys are following or not. There's a lot of things going on, and I won't get into too much detail, but with China and Russia and they call them the BRICS nations, and what they're doing regarding trying to essentially eliminate the U.S. dollar as the reserve currency, which means basically when other countries do trading, they all do it in U.S. dollar for the most part. So that happening, and they're also trying to create their own SWIFT system, meaning that, you know, for like oil, for example, or even trading, all the other nations convert their money to U.S. dollars, and they go through the SWIFT system or whatever. So they're trying to, or they're saying that they are, that it'll be done in September, that they'll be able to trade basically in currencies beside the U.S., which makes the U.S. dollar a lot more valuable than it would be. And I had a writer for, he has a site, The Daily Economist, Secrets of the Fed, and he was on talking about some of this and the ramifications of...
I want to hear more about it, if you will. Hang on. We'll come back with Dave from Nonpartisan Liberty for All. It's his show. We'll come back with him here in moments. Hour number three is on the way. It's Free Talk Live. Our number is 855-450-FREE.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict.
legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
How many lawyers does it take to change a light bulb? None. They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, April 10th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.47 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,203 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports President Obama went to Panama last night for an historic meeting with his Cuban counterpart, Raul Castro, on the sidelines of a major regional summit. Looming large in the meeting is the ongoing review of Cuba's inclusion on U.S. list of international sponsors of terrorism, with President Obama saying he will soon decide on the issue. Obama offered an upbeat assessment on the likely removal of Cuba from the list, saying the U.S. would need strong evidence to support putting the nations on the list, which historically has not been the case. The U.S. traditionally has used terror listings to bludgeon international rivals. There was never much justification for Cuba to be on the list beyond long-standing U.S. acrimony towards them. Even with the removal seemingly imminent, U.S. officials are indicating that they're holding off while trying to get certain guarantees from Cuba about their access to diplomatic facilities. This underscores the reality that the terror list has little to do with terrorism, and Cuba's presence or removal from the list will have nothing to do with terrorism. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Coinbase has more than 1 million consumer wallets and is trusted by over 25,000 merchants, including Overstock.com, Khan Academy, Reddit, and of course, FPP. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports a supervisor in the U.S. Secret Service has been placed on administrative leave following an incident last week in which the official allegedly made an unwanted sexual advance at the agency's Washington, D.C. headquarters. Senior Supervisor Xavier Morales is accused of making the advance on a female subordinate, according to ABC News and The Washington Post. The Secret Service, an agency under the oversight of the Department of Homeland Security, did not initially comment on the matter. However, the agency's director later made a statement to the Post. The Homeland Security Inspector General's office is handling the investigation along with the D.C. Metro Police Department's Sex Crimes Unit. Authorities said Morales had been placed on leave and his security clearances have been suspended pending the outcome of an investigation. Two sources close to the investigation said in the Post report that Morales inappropriately grabbed the female subordinate on March 31st following a party at a downtown restaurant. The incident was reported on April 2nd and several interviews were conducted that day. A gathering at a restaurant celebrated Morales' new assignment to head the agency's field office in Louisville, Kentucky. He was scheduled to take the helm in Louisville this week. It is not clear whether the investigation will affect that assignment. The unnamed female employee reportedly told investigators that Morales, who is married to a Secret Service agent, admitted at the restaurant that he had feelings for her and sought a sexual relationship. His advances supposedly turned physical when the two returned to the agency's headquarters and the woman said she fended him off until he relented. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a South Carolina police officer has been fired after being charged with murder for shooting a man in the back as he fled, but questions remained on Wednesday about some details of the killing that was filmed by a witness. The shooting occurred on Saturday in North Charleston, but it gained national media attention on Tuesday when the video became public. The mayor said that Michael Slager has been fired, but said the city would cover insurance for his family until his wife gives birth. She is currently 8 months pregnant. Walter Scott had been stopped by police for a broken taillight on his vehicle. According to legal experts, the city of North Charleston, which has a 2015 budget of $105.6 million, about one-third of which goes to the police department, could end up paying out a significant amount to Scott's family. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Right now, it's looking like tonight's record $500 million Powerball drawing could be canceled, as embarrassed lottery officials have admitted they lost the balls. Douglas Bronstein, deputy director of the Multi-State Lottery Association, addressed the press moments ago. We have a quote. We know how important the balls are to a successful drawing. I saw them the other day, and I'm sure they'll turn up somewhere. Bronstein says it's usually marketing director Ben Callahan's job to keep an eye on the balls, but when reached for comment, Callahan said he just sits next to the balls. It's not his job to know where they are every second of every day. According to Bronstein, it's crucial they find the balls before tonight's drawing. Quote, we'd love to use different balls, but these ones have the numbers on them. Bronstein added that once they figure out where the balls are, they promise to keep them in some sort of case instead of just lying around the office. When we return, we'll meet some of the undeterred Powerball superfans who are camping out before the big drawing dressed as their favorite numbers.
This is the Onion News Network.
Now more Free Talk Live. As we launch into the third hour of the program, we will take your calls about anything. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. Adamo Freeman still in jail. Will be there for several days in Zanesville, Ohio. We talked about that earlier tonight. If you didn't get the story, you can go to copblock.org. Story's also up over at freekeen.com. And you can learn more about that. Of course, you can listen to us later on in archive form over at freetalklive.com. You can subscribe to our podcast there. With you in studio, Ian here.
And Daryl.
And don't forget to join us via the telephone here tonight, 855-450-FREE, or Skype. Skype username, lrn.fm. We do have with us Dave Bourne. He is the host of Nonpartisan Liberty for All, and he's on via Skype right now. Dave, you're back on Free Talk Live. Can you recap for our listeners who might just be tuning in as to what you were getting at with this whole U.S. dollar international thing?
Yeah, so once a month I have a guy on, Ken Shorgen, who's also on Angel Clark's show once a week as well on LRN. And he writes for a bunch of different websites and talks about geopolitics and the economy and things like that. So actually last night, it actually aired on LRN during the podcast loop. But we've been talking a lot about this where, and so have other independent media. So I just make it clear, it's not just him, but it's not something you're going to hear, you know, on government media. But essentially, with all the things that have been going on with, you know, if you want to call them proxy wars or you know, things between Russia or whatever, that China, along with Russia and some of these other nations, are calling them the BRICS nations, have gotten together, and just to summarize, on a number of things, one being their own World Bank. They are setting up a SWIFT system, which essentially what I understand that is currently the U.S. dollar is the reserve currency, meaning all trading between nations, for the most part, is done in U.S. dollars. And you need to convert those your currency to U.S. dollars to do trade. And, of course, there's fees associated with that. And especially with oil, and OPEC, you know, made an agreement that everything goes through this. So essentially, they're trading especially oil, but other things, converting to U.S. dollars so they can trade between countries. And of course, this heavily benefits the U.S. and they're even able to inflation is kind of dumped off in a sense on other countries. So with China and these other nations getting together and forming this World Bank and a SWIFT system, they're trying to essentially get everyone off of the U.S. as a reserve currency and get rid of a reserve currency altogether. So the implications that can have on the U.S. dollar are huge. I mean, from his opinion...
So wait, Dave, what you're saying is that they're going to get off the dollar, but there's not going to be another reserve currency to replace it?
Well, this is kind of based a lot on Ken's research, but from what he was saying, the goal essentially is still everyone would trade with their own currency, but it would be backed by gold. So they're, you know, basically verifying that everything is backed by gold, whether it's currency or a note or something like that, where again, and this is based on his information, but it's to move more towards a currency backed by something. So when they trade, whether it's in their own currency or in a note that is backed by gold that has been confirmed, you know, if you have something that says, yes, this has been verified, there's whatever, $10 million in gold sitting here to back this, that it would be done that way. So, yeah, essentially to not really replace the reserve currency. But
haven't they been saying for years that China was going to stop using the dollar as a reserve currency?
I've been hearing that pretty much my entire life.
Right.
And one thing that I find odd is the people that seem to be alarmist about this, like the people that want the U.S. government to collapse, that are saying, oh, the U.S. dollar is not going to be the reserve currency anymore. That's going to destroy the economy. Wouldn't you welcome that? Because that would then, okay, it destroys the U.S. economy. U.S. government hopefully collapses.
Yeah.
Like, isn't that long something term you should be cheering on? Like, I've heard there's a group called Anarchist for Hillary, not because they think that Hillary is going to, you know, be a freedom-loving president, but because they realize Hillary is probably going to speed up the collapse. So go for the worst possible scenario to get what you ultimately want?
Yeah, but I think the one difference here is that it's not talk anymore. I mean, I don't know what it was based on in the past, but they are actually, you know, it's been confirmed that they're creating the SWIFT system. Now, what's going to happen as a result of that, I guess, is all speculation.
It's hard to really get too worked up about it. I mean, you're not upset about it, right? Like, you want the dollar to be pulled from reserve currency status, right?
Yeah, no, I mean, it should be. And I think long term, if that's what happened, and if everything was backed by gold or some other asset, I think that's a positive. But in the short term, that's where, you know, and you can speculate. I mean, of course, he's speculating that things are going to be, you know, crazy where you have riots in the streets and stuff like that.
It sounds unbelievable to me also that any major government would want their currency to be backed by gold. That doesn't make sense to me. I don't know why they would do that.
It's in the, from what I understand it, again, I mean, I'm not an expert on this or anything, but it's more in when you're trading with other nations. You know, right now, I mean, everything, the U.S. dollar is based on nothing, and the other countries are really forced to use U.S. currency.
Yeah, but if they use their own currency, those would also be based on nothing, and that's part of the game, is that the different central banks around the world can just print up money, and based on a variety of factors, the dollars trade at different rates with.
Well, that's what's supposed to eliminate that and go to something where, you know, the currency is based on gold instead of the other way around.
Well, I hope you're right. I mean, it sounds pie in the sky. And Dave, thanks for the call tonight. What's your website, by the way, for listeners?
Oh, nonpartisanlibertyforall.com.
All right, thanks for the call tonight. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You know, it's hard to really, to me, it sounds very speculative. I don't know. I haven't done the research, and nor do I really want to.
Yeah, and it also seems kind of odd that, you know, right now there's no currency in the world issued by any government that is backed up by an actual thing of value.
Right.
There's the claim that I believe it's the Australian dollar that's backed up by some commodities, but it's one of these things to where basically they're backing it with their stock market. So it's not like tangible items.
Yeah.
It would be akin to if the U.S. dollar, instead of being backed by the full faith and credit of the United States government, was backed by the Dow Jones Industrial Index or something.
More pieces of paper.
Right. So ultimately, it's basically, you know, like, we're backing this piece of paper with this other piece of paper. So there's not any government right now that issues money that is backed by gold, silver, platinum, plutonium.
It's not in their interest to do that.
Pluto figurines, Star Wars figures, anything. So it's they're all backed by just, well, we say it's worth this, so therefore take it. So it doesn't make any sense that they would then say, oh, okay, except for when we trade this to other governments, and then it's going to be backed by something other than our military. It makes no sense to me why they would do that. Maybe they will. I don't know. You know, my ideal solution for currency is to get rid of legal tender laws and allow anybody to issue their own currency. And if people want to take it, people take it. If people don't want to take it, they don't take it.
Let the market decide on currency. Yeah, I totally agree. And I guess, you know, if more develops, hopefully we'll hear about it here on Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So we were talking earlier about you gave us this YouTube video you'd watched of a guy with an earpiece, somebody giving him instructions over the earpiece as he's talking to people, asking them for just their name, essentially, and where they're from.
Right.
And as though he's going to like perform some sort of psychic trick, but it's really his buddy who's typing up on Facebook.
I don't even think that this was him pretending to do a psychic trick.
Oh, really? Okay.
Like, he was pretending to do like a man on the street sort of thing.
Uh-huh.
And then he was just asking them questions in amongst the conversation. Like, he was having a conversation with them. In amongst the conversation, he was saying, so didn't you go to like San Bernardino High School and you graduated in 1994? They're like,
but they're surprised he would have known that, right?
They were very surprised.
Okay. I've seen a version where it's like a psych, like he's like, I'm a psychic, you know, that kind of thing. But there was another one I wanted to tell you about that was related to that, and I haven't forgotten about it. We'll come back to it. 855-450-FREE, plus more about your privacy on the way, and Bitcoin nano satellites. We'll find out what that is.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Never, ever send a follow-up email asking, did you get my email? Email 101, if it didn't bounce back undeliverable, it got where you sent it. And avoid transmedia pestering, like calling to ask, did you get my email, or emailing to say I left you a voicemail. If your emails and voicemails aren't being acknowledged, your problem isn't technology, it's technique. Is your message concise and understandable? Have you boiled it down to seem as relevant as possible to the recipient? In other words, is it the opposite of spam or junk mail? All of this really matters if you're a job seeker. But even if you're not, with money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you may take control toll-free here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, Ian here.
And Daryl.
Don't forget to join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com. Where you can enjoy the features. You can create the content there on the front page of the site. It's all listener created. You can submit content to our Reddit-based system, and then other listeners can vote up if they like, down if they don't. It's all totally free at freetalklive.com, so go there and enjoy. Another great site for liberty-oriented news is freedomsphoenix.com. They're uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies every day at freedomsphoenix.com. Their readers get the real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. freedomsphoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to freedomsphoenix.com. You can sign up for their free daily dispatch. That, again, is freedomsphoenix.com. So, Daryl, we were talking about there was this video that you'd seen where there's a guy with an earpiece and he's just talking with people on the streets. I thought, I just misunderstood what you had said earlier. I thought he just asked them for basic info, like their name and where they're from. And then his confederate on the earpiece was looking them up on Facebook, and then he would start asking questions about their lives that he wouldn't necessarily know.
Right. So right. I was able to watch about 30 seconds of the video. It's mm-hmm. from BuzzFeed. I will post the link on the Facebook and Twitter. And so he asks somebody, you know, what's your name and where you're from? The guy in the van pulls it up and he says, ask him what he thinks about Jared Leto's hair. And Jared Leto's some celebrity. So apparently the guy had posted
a post about
you know, the person's hair. So it starts off where he just asks, you know, sort of like benign, strange questions. And then towards the end, he starts asking specifics like, you know, what was it like growing up in such and so town?
Mm.
And then they're like, wait, what? And then they explain about, you know, internet privacy, like, you know, be careful what you post.
Because they're just posting publicly.
Because we've got somebody in the van, and they pulled all of this info up.
And that's because these people were just posting publicly to their Facebook. They had no privacy restrictions on whatsoever. And they don't think about that. They don't think about the ramifications of what that could mean. So a variant I saw on that was, I think it was the Jack Vale channel on Facebook. He's one of the Facebook. It was the Jack Vale channel on YouTube. Jack Vale is one of the YouTube pranksters, and he does some pretty fun stuff. He actually created the pooter, as it is called. Have you seen the pooter before?
Is that the one where the person pretends to fart?
Yeah, it's the pooter is the device. So he made this device.
Oh, he's the guy that invented the device.
Correct.
Okay.
And it's something that you can conceal in the palm of your hand, and that way you squeeze it, you just sort of squeeze your hand, and it makes this very convincing fart noise, sort of on the lines of the old whoopee cushion,
yeah.
But, you know, concealable in the palm of your hand.
I've actually seen machines that, you know, it's a sizable machine that you can't hold in the palm of your hand, but you push a button.
This is not a machine.
And then it remote controls, or you can do sensor activate to where if somebody walks in front of
yes,
it.
Yes, you're talking about something with a speaker. This is a. Yeah. This is not a machine. This is just a, I don't know what it's made out of, some kind of plastic or whatever, but
okay.
It makes a, you know, fart noise. And so, anyway, that's who Jack Vale is. He's got some pretty entertaining videos out there.
Is this the guy that, if it's who I'm thinking of, he's a jackass, basically, where he'll go into the hood and start harassing thugs?
No. Jack
to Vale's basically not. Prove that a thug will beat you up?
He's done some farting by people in the hood before, which has been somewhat dangerous.
No, so I've seen one to where the guy goes up and he just starts randomly pulling up pants
of
people in the hood.
No, that's one of the dumbest channels I've ever seen.
And then the guy also does the farting prank, but he will actually lay his hands on someone and like pull their head towards his butt. And so like this guy, he's aggressing
people.
Against people
yeah.
by, you know, grabbing them.
Right.
But he's basically proving that a thug will beat you up.
Right.
And then while he's...
And you might deserve it,
getting
too.
Beaten yeah. up, he's like, it's a prank! Stop right. hitting me! It's a prank! There's a camera! Like, you can't do that. Like, you know, you can't just go assault people and say, it's a prank! Ha-ha!
No, I agree. That is not Jack Vale. Jack should not be confused with that channel that you're talking about.
Okay.
I think the channel you're referring to is OCK TV, O-C-K.
I have no TV. Clue. I've seen some of the videos, yeah. and there's one where he actually gets a gun pulled on him. Well, because he's walking around with water guns, and he's like, hey, you want to buy a gun?
Yeah.
And the guy says, MF-er, why do I need a gun? I already got a
right.
gun. And he pulls the gun out and like shoves it in his face.
Yeah, that's one of the dumbest channels, one of the worst prank channels, I think. I mean, there's some pretty outrageous
pranks. I don't even think
pull.
You could call that a prank channel.
Well, you know, some of the stuff they do is, I mean...
He's trying to be a prank channel, but he's not a prank
yeah.
channel.
I mean, I don't like the pranks where they assault people. I don't think that's okay. I mean, obviously, I'm a liberty-minded person, and I don't support aggressing against people. And the ones where they're pulling up the pants is so outrageous to
yeah.
me. And anyway, that is not Jack Vale. Jacks are much more calm, kind of friendly pranks.
Okay.
He's a much more friendly prankster, I guess you could say. Much more family-friendly, if you will.
Okay.
Again, farting is about as extreme as it gets on Jack Vale's channel. So one of them, they're apparently on Instagram, and I know nothing about Instagram. Okay, I don't.
People
think
post pictures.
Yeah, I know they post
pictures. That's all I know.
And there's filters. So that's all I know about Instagram. But
filters?
Apparently, filters for the pictures. So like, if you want a sepia tone, you can put the sepia tone on it or whatever.
Ah, okay.
But apparently there's a feature on Instagram where you can see, based on a map, based on GPS, people posting pictures.
Okay.
So, like, if you were in Keene Central Square and somebody posted a picture nearby, you would be able to see that on the map, presuming they're posting publicly. Right?
Okay.
So they went to, like, Venice Beach or something like that, where there's a bunch of people around, and it's guaranteed that people are going to be posting pictures of themselves. You know, I'm eating an ice cream cone on Venice Beach. You know, that kind of thing.
Okay.
And so they found someone posting a picture on Venice Beach. Then they would walk in that general vicinity until they found that person. Because they're, you know, selfies and things like that, right? So
right,
people
right.
are not just taking pictures of sunsets, they're taking pictures of themselves at Venice Beach. So they would then find the person who took the selfie, and they would go up and start talking to this person. And I forget under which pretense they would just go up and talk to them, but and it might have been the psychic thing. I think it might have been, yeah, it was, you know, he was pretending to be psychic, right? So he'd go up and start asking them, and it was the same thing with a guy he had an earpiece in, and someone
okay.
was feeding him information. And, or no, excuse me, it wasn't an earpiece. He just researched them or whatever, because basically finding that first picture allowed them to find their Instagram profile and
okay.
then see all the other posts that they'd made. And so he would start asking them questions about, and he would like know their name. He would know where they were from. He would know, you know, where they went on vacation. And they were totally freaked out about, how could you know all of this stuff? You must be psychic. And he was like, no, we saw your post on Instagram. you know, so he told him at the end of the prank. And so I thought that was an even better version of what you were talking about, where he didn't have to ask them a single question.
Right.
He just found their post publicly and then researched them a little bit, found them physically because he was there at that time. And it was a real mind blower for those people.
I also saw one where somebody did something similar, like, you know, figure out who's nearby, walked up and he would approach people. Hey, we've been chatting on Grindr.
Yeah. We'll come back with more here in moments. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here. Share your thoughts. Whatever. Internet privacy. We can come back to all of it here in moments. Plus, Bitcoin nano satellites. Daryl will tell us about that. Still to come here on Free Talk Live.
Have you ever felt like the United States government knows way too much about your financial affairs? I continue to hear stories about property seizures, frozen bank accounts, confiscation of stocks and bonds. It makes me wonder if the U.S. citizen will ever again have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Unfortunately, with the Drug and Money Laundering Act, the IRS Revenue Ruling 6045 of 1984, and the Trading with the Enemy Act and Franklin D. Roosevelt's Executive Order of 1933, some precious metal holdings are subject to government intervention. For this reason, Midas Resources has prepared a report explaining the boundaries of trading precious metals privately. Whether if you have any intention of trading with Midas Resources or not, I have instructed my representatives to give this report out free. Call for your free copy at 1-800-686-2237. When investing, always proceed with caution. Again, call 1-800-686-2237. Exercise your legal right to trade metals privately. 1-800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
One of the counselor's excuses for her behavior after call accused her of engaging in stealing. This is stealing. You're taking something from somebody who believed they owned something, and by all evidence did own something. You're taking it from them. And as you say, Mark, this goes on all across the country. They're called tax sales or tax deeds. Whenever people drop back in not being able to pay property taxes, in this case, it's because of the down economy. These people are having a tough time. At one point, she got very frustrated, and she said, well, it's not stealing because it's the law. So apparently when the law says you can take something that's not yours, it's not stealing. And now all the law is, as you pointed out, you talk about the Constitution, that's supposed to be the highest law of the land. The law is just words on paper written down by men and women. Some of them signed their names to it, but most of us, in fact, 99.999% of us, never signed anything in regards to their laws.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free if you want. And bring up anything that's on your mind, 855-450-FREE. Adamo Freeman currently in jail for several days in Zanesville, Ohio. The story is over at freekeen.com and copblock.org. If you missed that earlier tonight, you can get that later on in our archives over at freetalklive.com once I get them online later. And, of course, you can join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And you can call toll-free, 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. Plus, if you want to help support Free Talk Live, we'd love for you to do that. One of the ways you can do it is by shopping with us. You go to shop.freetalklive.com, and you enter Amazon through the links you'll find there. And there's Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, Amazon US. You just go into the right Amazon for you and get your shopping taken care of. Free Talk Live will get a cut of your purchase. It's that simple. It's the same great Amazon selection. It's huge. The same great free Super Saver shipping deals, everything you're used to. It's just you're entering through our affiliate links, so we get the cut over at shop.freetalklive.com. Let's go to Skype, where we have Frode on the line. Skype, Frode, you're on Free Talk Live. We have Frode on Skype. Frode going once.
Hi, guys.
Hello there.
How are you doing tonight?
Hey, where are you calling from tonight?
I'm calling from Norway.
Ah, excellent. Frode from Norway. Go ahead, sir.
Well, I have a question about democracy and when it comes to voting.
Sure.
Have you voted at the last election for the president?
I did, yes.
Can I ask you why you voted?
You know, it's an old habit at this point as far as why I voted for presidency. I can't really say I was particularly excited about any of the people that were on the ballot. And I think I actually voted for George Phillies the last time around because he was on in...
That was 2008.
Oh, that was 2008.
See, last election was 2012.
Okay.
And
Phillies wasn't on?
No, he wasn't. You were running for state rep in 2012, so yeah. You also voted for yourself. I'm fairly certain you were excited about your own candidacy.
Not really. I mean, I don't get excited about politics generally. But
right, but there are other races on the ballot other than just president.
Sure, but you were asking specifically about president, right, Frode?
Yeah.
Right.
I'm just thinking about quitting to vote at the elections because it seems like it's not helping. It's not changing anything. It doesn't really matter what you vote for.
Oh, of course. I mean, at the federal level, I totally agree with what you're saying there. I mean, you can vote for anybody at the federal level, and they're all a bunch of scumbags, so it's not going to do anything. And, of course, the libertarians aren't ever going to come close to, you know, cracking 2%.
Right, but not voting also hasn't... There have been people not voting for as long as there has been voting, and that hasn't really changed anything either.
I agree with that. I mean, nothing's going to change anything at the federal level as far as, you know, working within or outside of the system, voting, not voting. They're just going to keep trucking forward and doing whatever it is they want to do until, you know, it all comes crashing down, maybe due to the failure of the dollar or overextending themselves all around the world with the military and overspending. I don't know. I really don't know when it's all going to come to an end. But no government has lasted forever. That's
but
for sure.
Is it a little like this? If you don't vote, you can't complain?
Well, that's, I think, a ridiculous statement. And that's just a blow
claim.
Off. That's just a way for someone to blow off what you're saying when they don't want to hear what you have to say.
And there are also people that say, if you do vote, you can't complain.
I've heard that too.
I didn't vote for any of the people that are in office, so does that mean that I have a right to complain? And I've also heard people say that, well, you voted for a third party guy, so you wasted your vote. And I said, based on that theory, you voted for the guy that came in second. Didn't you waste your vote too?
Well, what they're saying when they're saying to you that, oh, if you voted, you can't complain, or if you didn't vote, you can't complain, they're saying, I don't want to hear your complaints.
Right.
That's all there's. It's just a way of placing blame on you, though.
So in a nutshell, democracy doesn't really is not a good way of doing it in
no,
a way?
No, of course not. I mean, any kind of system that codifies the ability to have human beings rule over others is a problematic system, especially when it's forced on everybody without their consent.
Well, but they claim that you consent because you exist in the geographic area in which the... I know it's not consent, but they're claiming that.
Sure. And just like a rapist would claim his victims consented too. She wanted it.
Most people have an idea in their mind when they hear democracy, like, you know, voting, elections, mm-hmm. and America.
Right.
But let me really explain what democracy is.
Please.
Democracy, and a lot of people will say democracy is 51% telling the other 49% what to do. And that's not accurate either. Democracy is a plurality of people that get to elect officials or set policy that the majority of people have to abide by. And why do I say a plurality of people? Because in most elections, you don't have 100% voter turnout. Even in the countries where voting is mandatory, they don't have 100% voter turnout. So in the U.S., it's on average around 50%, slightly under in the off-year elections where it's just Congress and not the president. So I think last election, 2014, the national average was 40%. So you have... Mm-hmm. In some cases, it's not even a majority of those people that are setting the policy. So let's just say 40% of 40%.
Right.
That's nowhere near a majority of people that are setting policies that the majority of people have to abide by. So you have a plurality dictating to the majority. It's not majority rule. It's mm-hmm. minority rule.
But the problem is also that it seems like there's no alternatives to democracy in a way.
Well, the alternative is to not have a system. I mean, to let the market decide, to have people consent into organizations, societies that are actually real societies, ones that are based on voluntary consent and a voluntary order.
Yeah, but wouldn't a voluntary system kind of... need a ruler or a president that's kind of the chief of the system?
No, if you want to set up a system that way, you're certainly welcome to do it. I mean, if people want to join that system, they should be free to do so. If people want to join a system where Frode is in charge because Frode is so great at deciding things for people's lives, then, you know, they should be free to do that. I'm not going to join that system, but if
Are
others,
sure?
I mean, you'd have to really persuade me, I guess. I'm not going to say that I'm totally closed to the idea.
There have been stateless societies throughout history, and just as no government lasts forever, no stateless society lasts forever either.
That's
but there have been stateless societies that have lasted for hundreds and thousands of years. So it is possible to have a society without a state. It is possible to have a state without society.
Unfortunately, we're a long way away from that happening. Frode, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. You know, one other thing to add about voting. I agree with Frode that it's completely pointless at the national level. It's just an almost total waste of time. The only reason it's not a waste of time is because there are local names on the ballot. And in New Hampshire, at least... those races can make a difference. The people who are winning or losing in those races, the people who get those seats in the state house, they are people who can work towards more liberty. The more freedom-oriented people we can get elected here, the better. We've seen liberty-oriented legislation actually have success in New Hampshire, and that's because of the people who've moved here, in a lot of cases, as part of the Free State Project. It's because of a lot of New Hampshire natives who love liberty and the people who are out there willing to come out and vote and support them. If they didn't have people out there helping with their campaigns and voting and, you know, working the political system, we wouldn't have the same level of success with rolling back the state.
And don't forget people acting as citizen lobbyists going to testify to legislative committees that have helped pass and helped reject bills.
All right, we'll come back with more. That's all happening here in New Hampshire. You can learn more at freestateproject.org. More Free Talk Live coming up.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You're faking it. You go around pretending everything's okay. You're irritable, you lose sleep, and your mind is racing with fearful thoughts. You want it to stop. You just don't know what to do. I'm Lucinda Bassett, founder of the Midwest Center for Stress and Anxiety. I can show you how to make it stop without abusing alcohol or taking medication. I did it, and so have hundreds of thousands of people just like you. Please, call now.
Call now, and we'll send you this wonderful free CD. 1-800-749-4061. 1-800-749-4061. 1-800-749-4061.
For over 5 years, you've been hearing about the Berkey guy, so you may know a few things about him. For example, you are well aware of the superior quality and effectiveness of Berkey water filters and accessories. But did you know the Berkeys have had independent lab tests done to prove just how effective they are? It's true, and he can email you the test results. Just visit GoBerkey.com. You may also know that the Berkey guy has helped tens of thousands of people get better prepared. Now here's something you may not know. GoBerkey.com has amazing specials and deals all the time on a wide variety of survival and preparedness products, most ready to ship same day. Visit the Berkey guy at GoBerkey.com and be sure to click the red Products on Sale Now button. You can always call toll-free 877-886-3653. Again, that's 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com, home of the Berkey guy.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time, call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. Moments remain, hopefully enough time to talk about Bitcoin nanosatellites. Daryl has that story here tonight. Of course, you can join us on the lines at 855-450-FREE or via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. And, of course, you can help support the show by becoming an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com and get perks like access to the amp-only call-in lines, amp-only Facebook group, and more. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Let's go to Andrew. He's in Wisconsin. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Andrew.
Good evening, gentlemen. Thanks for taking my call.
Hey.
I called in because I want to respond that you were talking about the voting. And I have not voted in the last three presidential elections. it blows my mind how obvious the real problem in this issue is, that I almost never hear it talked about on alternative radio, or especially not in mainstream shows. Because here's the thing. Remember when they were just constantly harping about voter fraud, oh, the issue is voter fraud. When in my mind, these are computerized machines handling the voting process. It's not voter fraud, it's election fraud. What can you do with a computerized program?
It's not computers everywhere.
Right.
We still have paper ballots here in New Hampshire.
Yeah, exactly.
And they're computer scanned.
Not everywhere in New Hampshire, and there's a lot of the smaller towns where they have to hand count every ballot.
Right, and that's the great deception, because it's not everywhere. If it was everywhere, it'd be way too obvious. But here's the thing. Let me give you an example. In the last election, Ron Paul in Iowa, right, he's filling stadiums, filling them. And then over across town, there's Mitt Romney in the basement of a hotel with 75 people and all the mainstream press. The next day, you hear all the, you know, who voted and the exit polls. And gosh, you know, I just don't understand. I can't seem to get Ron Paul's people out to the voting booth.
Well,
like,
and in Iowa, because they have a caucus, it's not a secret vote. So in Iowa, for the caucuses, and there are other states that have caucuses, what they do with the caucus is people meet up in the location where the caucus is, and then they go separate into groups. And, all right, this little group over here is the group for Mitt Romney. This group is the group for Rick Santorum. This group is the group for Ron Paul. And then those groups will then, oh, wait, the Ron Paul group's bigger than ours and bigger than everybody else, so we need to go join that group. And so it's one of those visual things to where they can manipulate the results. It's sort of one of those things, sort of like the Ash experiments, to where people don't want to really be seen as, you know, standing out from the crowd and being different. The Ash experiment is the one where they have 11 people that are Confederates and one person is the test subject. And they ask the people, which one of these lines is longer? And 11 people will give the wrong answer. And then the 12th person, somewhere near like 90% of the time, would give the wrong answer because he didn't want to be seen as standing out.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have these not secret vote caucuses, people behave differently than if it was write your vote on this piece of paper.
Right. And I'm not necessarily a big avid Ron Paul fan, but it just, to me, from an amateur standpoint, looking down, I'm seeing, wow, this guy's, you know, filling stadiums, this guy's got a room of 75 people, and then I'm told, you know, they just are astounded that their people didn't come out and vote the next day. But regardless of all that, I would go back to my other point, and just the fact that you're right, it's not in every situation, but there is a great deal of computerized voting, especially in the larger cities where, you know, greater numbers are going to have a greater impact, right?
Certainly.
So, I don't know. I just think more attention ought to be given to it. If you Google that stuff online, you can find all kinds of examples where there's, you know, eyebrow-raising results coming out of
Your solution? Just get rid of the computer counting machines?
There was fraud before those.
What's that?
There was fraud before those machines existed. Right,
right, there was.
Yeah.
And, you know, there was also fraud. There's fraud in the way candidates get on the ballot, to where in Pennsylvania, if a minor party or independent candidate turns in a petition and then one of the major parties challenges the petition, the minor party candidate then has to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars defending their petitions. And if they win, they don't get reimbursed by the major party that challenged their petitions. So there's financial incentive not to petition to try to get on the ballot in some places.
Exactly. Well, your question is valid. What would I propose? I would propose complete transparency. Anybody, I shouldn't say anybody, I have to have some sort of selection process, but pretty much anybody could go in and you know, maybe a group of some sort go in and hand count, say, hey, I really question the results in this. I want to see each of the handwritten ballots, and I want to, you know, I want to count them. Or I want
in
to
New
have
Hampshire,
it,
you can go and observe the count, as I understand it.
Absolutely.
Right, yeah, but after the election is over and the count is done, you can't do your own recount.
Oh, I see what you mean. You mean after the fact. Okay, gotcha. But you can go in there while it's happening, and you can observe the actual counting.
You can observe them pushing the button on the machine, and the machine spitting out, this is what the vote total is.
But as you said, in New Hampshire, in some places, they actually do hand count.
Right.
You can observe that.
Right.
I think there's a process that you have to go through to be able to do that.
Okay, I thought they let it just anybody
scary.
In.
I don't know,
I mean,
if they do or not.
Right, it's a little scary. All of us know somebody who's really good on a computer. That person could walk in and say, okay, between the 10 people in this room, I want everybody to vote. Is there election fraud possible? So 8 of them say no, 2 of them say yes. Computer program comes out and says, oh, look at this. 7 of them said yes. 3 of them said no.
Andrew, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate the thoughts, and I can appreciate the concern. I mean, yeah, there's an incentive to commit fraud on these elections. I mean, especially in the bigger ones, when somebody is up for a Senate seat or something like that, that there's money involved and there's power involved, and so they have the incentive to commit fraud. No doubt about that.
Yeah, and I think one of the things that leads to some of the, I don't want to necessarily say conspiracy theories, mm-hmm. but some of the theories about the ability of these vote counting machines is that the companies that make the vote counting machines refuse to make the code public. So,
that's,
for instance,
really disturbing.
Slot machines that are operating in Las Vegas, the coding on how those work is made public,
mm-hmm.
so that
it's open source.
You know, well, not open source in that anybody can go and
change it. You can't modify
change
the
it,
code, but you can
but
read it.
People
you can
can
audit it.
Right, like, you know, there are processes to where you can be able to see the coding.
All right, I
want to
hear about
how this
Bitcoin
works.
Nanosatellites before
so,
we get out of here.
The Bitcoin nanosatellites. One of the core developers, a gentleman by the name of Jeff Garzik, has signed a manufacturing contract with Deep Space Industries that will find it constructing 24 nanosatellites for a proposed BitSat program. The satellites are to cost about $1 million apiece.
Woo!
And let me skip down into the article here.
Jeez.
I've researched this before, so let me just go based off
yeah.
of memory.
What's the point of it?
These things are going to be about 4 inches by 4 inches by 1 foot.
Okay.
And they're basically going to be running the Bitcoin program. Mm. And they're going to be in space.
Right.
So that if, you know, the internet gets taken out here on Earth, hmm. you've still got 24 satellites in space running the Bitcoin protocol.
Which in theory you'd be able to communicate with, or at least get their signal to you. You'd be able to receive it.
I'm not sure if it would be able to send the signal, but until internet, it would have to be able to receive it somehow. I don't know exactly how that would work.
Usually the point of a satellite is to communicate, right?
Right. So, you know, I don't know if your smartphone would be able to get the signal directly from the satellite.
Seems unlikely.
That's why I said I don't know exactly how the sending and receiving from the satellite to the internet
I'm
would
interested
work.
In knowing more about that as well. I've heard about these sort of these small satellites. I know the OuterNet system is talked about using something like that as
so,
well.
So let me just read something real quick. Garzik says that once the system is in place and all 24 satellites are deployed, the system will be capable of providing quote-unquote continuous global coverage. And
of Bitcoin.
Of Bitcoin.
Which I think the most exciting possibility for that might be that they would be getting Bitcoin into uninterneted versions of the world. Like, you know, the 4 billion
I think that's
people.
One of the possibilities. But also, then if all of the networks on Earth go out, you've still got satellites.
See you tomorrow night. FreeTalkLive.com.
Deep. Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinner time conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, April 10th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.47 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,203 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports President Obama went to Panama last night for an historic meeting with his Cuban counterpart, Raul Castro, on the sidelines of a major regional summit. Looming large in the meeting is the ongoing review of Cuba's inclusion on U.S. list of international sponsors of terrorism, with President Obama saying he will soon decide on the issue. Obama offered an upbeat assessment on the likely removal of Cuba from the list, saying the U.S. would need strong evidence to support putting the nations on the list, which historically has not been the case. The U.S. traditionally has used terror listings to bludgeon international rivals. There was never much justification for Cuba to be on the list beyond long-standing U.S. acrimony towards them. Even with the removal seemingly imminent, U.S. officials are indicating that they're holding off while trying to get certain guarantees from Cuba about their access to diplomatic facilities. This underscores the reality that the terror list has little to do with terrorism, and Cuba's presence or removal from the list will have nothing to do with terrorism. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Coinbase has more than 1 million consumer wallets and is trusted by over 25,000 merchants, including Overstock.com, Khan Academy, Reddit, and of course, FPP. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports a supervisor in the U.S. Secret Service has been placed on administrative leave following an incident last week in which the official allegedly made an unwanted sexual advance at the agency's Washington, D.C. headquarters. Senior Supervisor Xavier Morales is accused of making the advance on a female subordinate, according to ABC News and the Washington Post. The Secret Service, an agency under the oversight of the Department of Homeland Security, did not initially comment on the matter. However, the agency's director later made a statement to the Post. The Homeland Security Inspector General's office is handling the investigation, along with the D.C. Metro Police Department's Sex Crimes Unit. Authorities said Morales had been placed on leave and his security clearances have been suspended pending the outcome of an investigation. Two sources close to the investigation said in the Post report that Morales inappropriately grabbed the female subordinate on March 31st following a party at a downtown restaurant. The incident was reported on April 2nd and several interviews were conducted that day. A gathering at a restaurant celebrated Morales' new assignment to head the agency's field office in Louisville, Kentucky. He was scheduled to take the helm in Louisville this week. It is not clear whether the investigation will affect that assignment. The unnamed female employee reportedly told investigators that Morales, who is married to a Secret Service agent, admitted at the restaurant that he had feelings for her and sought a sexual relationship. His advances supposedly turned physical when the two returned to the agency's headquarters, and the woman said she fended him off until he relented. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a South Carolina police officer has been fired after being charged with murder for shooting a man in the back as he fled, but questions remained on Wednesday about some details of the killing that was filmed by a witness. The shooting occurred on Saturday in North Charleston, but it gained national media attention on Tuesday when the video became public. The mayor said that Michael Slager has been fired, but said the city would cover insurance for his family until his wife gives birth. She is currently 8 months pregnant. Walter Scott had been stopped by police for a broken taillight on his vehicle. According to legal experts, the city of North Charleston, which has a 2015 budget of $105.6 million, about one-third of which goes to the police department, could end up paying out a significant amount to Scott's family. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
After briefly reviewing several documents outlining his parents' dire financial circumstances today, 23-year-old Wesleyan University graduate Zach Wallace told reporters he had, quote, absolutely no clue how his mother and father are going to dig themselves out of the $35,000 of student loan debt they incurred to pay for his college education.
I mean, this is going to be really hard on my parents. When I was in college, I just assumed that, you know, they would pay off my student loans within a few years of me graduating. But I never realized how expensive college is going to be for them.
Wallace, who graduated with a film studies degree in 2012 and has since had two unpaid internships, told reporters that from the way prevailing interest rates are trending, his parents could easily be paying off his debt for the next quarter century.
They're going to be paying for the rest of their lives. And on top of it all, they have to help me out with my rent, too. I mean, it sucks. It really, really sucks.
This is the Onion News Network.
Say that one more time.
This is Free Talk Live. You are